I'm Alex Jones, your host. It's Wednesday, the 10th day of August, 2016. We'll be here for the next 4 hours. We have some special guests joining us. I'll tell you about a little bit later. But first off, boom, if you're a TV viewer, there it is, DrudgeReport.com. It wasn't the Russians. Assange fingers murdered DNC staffer. We pointed this out weeks ago, that this guy was high level over basically their email outreach for the party. And he was complaining of Sanders being cheated. How dare him think that you're supposed to win the popular vote and then the delegates are supposed to go along with that? How dare him? And so he got beaten, tortured, basically, shot to death, but not robbed. And other people have been found dead in their stairwells, dead on their couch. This is what follows behind Hillary. And then you got Debbie Wasserman Schultz, the image looking basically through the crack curtain at her prey. Simply amazing that this is all ongoing. Meanwhile, there's so many big stories, but this is indicative of the corruption. Bernie Sanders buys a $600,000 lakefront summer house, and he's got millions rolling in from book deals and other goodies, which is fine, except he acts like anybody making money is bad. That's how you build lake houses. That's how you build an economy. White people don't know what it's like to be poor. That's an actual quote. He talked about a lot of real issues with crony capitalism, but he called it free market. He said free market was the problem. Well, he knows good and well that countries that have any type of free market system are always vastly better. Vastly better than nations that don't have a free market system. So now he's bought his summer home, every dream of a good commissar. Now, getting into all the really serious news, Hillary Clinton's campaign has disavowed Mateen, Sadiq Mateen, the father of the mass murderer at the Pulse nightclub in Orlando, who showed up in Orlando and was put in the VIP section, vetted behind Hillary, right in the perfect spot, all by design. You can bet your bottom dollar. I'm still trying to figure out, what is the message? Just that, you know, here we are at an anti-gun rally, and, you know, here's the guy whose son's responsible for it all, and this guy puts out the same message, you know, go after the gays. But it's okay, because the Democrats are our minions. The Democrats are our demis. Well, I did more research on demis. That is exactly what all this is. That's minions, puppets. It's kind of like you got the main motorcycle gang, and they got little puppet motorcycle gangs that actually go around doing their dirty work for them. That's what the Democratic Party is for Saudi Arabia and others. A very serious situation. Also, leftists claim Trump supporters and that Trump wants some type of Hillary assassination plan. And all he said is exactly what Joe Biden said in 2008. So we're going to play those clips, and I'm putting it together in an article. I think Kit or Don is right now, so that we can put it out on air and put it out on the internet and show the incredible hypocrisy. That is a standard statement in history of the Second Amendment to say, if all else fails, we may have to go to the Second Amendment. That's what the founders said it was for. So I don't see why Trump needs to walk that back. It's not a threat of violence against Hillary. It's saying if the courts and everybody ban guns and come to confiscate them, it'll be 1776 all over again if you try to take our firearms. I'm excited to see up on the Drudge Report, radio host Michael Savage extends radio deal, adds cameras to Savage Nation. I talked a lot in the last few years with Savage about that. I guess kind of consulted with him on it just to try to help him out with any of my expertise, because I'm not in competition with Michael Savage. I am in competition with the globalists and the monopoly capitalists that want to use socialism as a control system worldwide to bring in an anti-human planetary tyranny. And so I am so excited to see Michael Savage's show continuing to grow and reach tens of millions more people. That is wonderful. I'm so thankful that despite the fact he's such a successful entrepreneur of 50 years, the best-selling author in health and wellness of all time, one of the biggest supplement formulators ever. Oh, yeah, people don't know that about him under another name, that he would sit there and spend 6, 7, 8 hours a day fighting the New World Order. If other successful, wealthy innovators would fight tyranny like Michael Savage has done, we wouldn't be in the situation we're in. And he's certainly a man in the arena. I didn't mean to start the broadcast talking about Michael Savage. I had just been reading that article during the break and thinking about it. There is a lot of really important news, obviously, up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. We're going to be going over a lot of that. The media is freaking out when Donald Trump jokes about the Second Amendment, stays silent when his life is threatened. But it was the crew that remembered three clips that we're going to be playing here in a few minutes and getting into that show that Hillary has gone further than what Trump just said, and so has Joe Biden. So we're going to put those clips together and then put them out in an article in the next hour at Infowars.com that really will shut these people down in a big way. And that's what we do. We folks ask how Infowars has some of the top stories in the world every day. And it's because we just take common sense and put it out in news reports and video reports, and we have memories. We have memories. And we go, oh, he just said if they get rid of all the other rights and overthrow the Second Amendment, we might have to use the Second Amendment to recapture it. That's in the Constitution. That's in the Bill of Rights. That's the old classic Americana statement. Boy, I hope we don't have to fall back on the Second Amendment that defends all the rest. I don't think Trump should even walk it back, because we've got Joe Biden saying, I got a Beretta and Obama tries to take it. You better watch it because I'm really good with it. A direct threat to the president, who was candidate Obama at the time. But that was then. Nobody wants your guns. Nobody's coming after your guns. You have a pledge from me. That was him trying to, again, deceive people. We have Hillary saying RFK. Hey, don't think Obama's going to stay in the race just because he's ahead. Remember what happened to Bobby Kennedy? Serious threat to Obama at the time. Those two don't like each other. So we're going to go to those. We're going to put a special report together. Here live on air, we'll take that clip, put it on YouTube, Facebook, and then get it out to counter them. When I look at what they're doing to the world's borders, I've never seen such incredible open border news as we're going to get to coming up. Also, on the economic front, I have never seen more top experts saying this bubble is as ripe as it gets. If it was an apple, it'd have worms all in it, it'd be oozing. You know, on the ground. It is ready to completely turn into ashes. And Mark Faber is issuing a stunning warning that a gigantic 50% stock market crash could be coming. Well, look, even though it's artificial, even though the stock market's rigged to a great extent, I don't want to just see it come collapsing because it hurts a lot of people. I'd like to see it reorganized somehow. But if it is going to crash, please let it crash before the election, because historically that means a landslide for Donald Trump. And then we've got the systems to reorganize and build a future and reindustrialize and innovate with high technology, but also agrarian systems of the new organic market that is taking over food production worldwide. That's why Putin has said Russia's main mission outside of technology development and minerals and oil and gas, energy, will be organic. We want to dominate the world in organic produce. It's sustainable. It's quality. Everyone wants it. The market's growing. Russia's smart. We should absolutely compete with Russia. All that'll do is give us more food, lower prices, higher quality. Globalism is about ending competition and shutting innovation down. But if the globalists control the collapse, they're going to use it to fully bring us into even more control, even more centralization, more domestication. We should nationalize German banks, warning Deutsche Bank teetering on edge of crisis. Top economist has warned Germany's biggest banks are about to collapse. Yeah, we've been telling you that for months. It'll make Lehman Brothers look like a cakewalk. That is all coming up. But before I get into that, I also want to mention just the culture wars that are happening. The globalists are trying to force feed anti-family, anti-human messages in entertainment, in news, in education. We all know that. But when they tried to force feed with hundreds of millions of dollars of production and advertising, three unattractive third wave feminists as the Ghostbusters, it is now one of the biggest losses in history. And it looks like no sequel, even though they announced it arrogantly when it was already failing. So Ghostbusters heading for 70 million plus loss, sequel unlikely, Hollywood Reporter. And you ask, why do I get into that? Even ahead of war news. Because they can't compete with just common sense. People don't want to be force-fed garbage. They want original, thought-provoking entertainment. And the real war for humanity is going on inside video games and movies and TV shows that are fiction-based. Most people have tuned out of news. In the news theater worldwide, pro-human populist truth is dominating and is now dominant. It's not just starting to take over. It has defeated them. That's why the system is moving to bring in censorship and control so that you have no other choice but to be force-fed their cultural poison. And we have a lot of news dealing with that here today and with censorship. Remember the Michael Phelps, by the way, two more gold medals yesterday. Michael Phelps, face meme explodes despite Olympics social media restrictions. That's right, the Olympics announced, and this is the type of regulations in the TPP, this is out of Forbes, that you can't even show his image, or they say even his name. Well, obviously, we have free speech to criticize. Obviously, we can make images and memes out of things. That's what our courts have ruled, European courts have ruled. Every culture accepts that. But see, under their new system, they're saying we won't tolerate you even commenting on things because we own the words themselves. This is just a taste of things to come. Also, dovetailing with that, there is a giant 16-page story out of The Intercept that has links to all the proof. I'm going to do a special report on this about privacy scandal haunts Pokemon Go's CEO. When Pokemon Go first came out and got big about a month ago, I went in, looked at the fact that it used Google Earth, looked at the fact that it used the former head of Google Earth who had to step down when he had the cars all over the world driving around, not just taking photos and video of your house, but stealing your data. And I came out and I said, this is the perfect way to have people go around your house and go around neighborhoods. They put the little pocket monsters where they want you to go on a path to document all that. Then they cosmology it all together. And I told people what it was doing. And there were leftist sites, Gizmodo, you name it, came out and said conspiracy kook claims this is really a Google conspiracy to have you go around and surveil yourself. This is while CNN even admits that almost all the new smart TVs watch and listen to you and sell the data to third parties. This is when it's admitted that the disgraced head of Google Earth and Google Maps, Google's spatial system working with the Pentagon, that's what it is, launched this, and it's admitted that the platform is paying for itself now with hundreds of millions of people walking around in their houses, their backyards, all of it geolocated to be meshed seamlessly. And then it goes further. It's your name, what you're doing. It turns out the app is grabbing data off your phone. It was worse than I said. But it isn't about, oh, look, I'm Alex Jones. I was right. I told you, see, this happened. It's that still the so-called leftists make fun of me for being the first to talk about it, for being right. Again, because the crew pointed it out to me. The research team. It's like weird. It's like you're not liberal. Not having knowledge and being ignorant is not liberal. Now, that said, we pointed out in the last month that a bunch of Democrat staffers are ending up dead. And they all deal with internet outreach and emails. And one of the head guys that was over outreach, high level with their emails, one of their top techs, ended up, you know, getting shot, tortured, beaten, shot in the back, nothing robbed. And now WikiLeaks has said, no, we have $20,000, you're finding out who did this to him. And they're now basically saying he was the source, not the Russians. We'll be back. Stay with us. In the history of modern warfare, but also in the last several thousand years of chivalry, from Japan to medieval Europe to ancient China, basically every culture was the same, including a lot of African tribes that I've studied. You didn't brag about people you'd killed boastfully. It was just something that was known you'd done. Or maybe you got another notch on your belt or another feather in your headdress. To have Hillary Clinton run around and say, yeah, we came to Libya, we saw, he died. Now it's a failed state, hundreds of thousands have died. The Arabs are ethnically cleansing blacks. That was the plan. And the Council on Foreign Relations has even come out and said, oh no, we actually wanted to make it a failed state. So that you could go in and exploit the resources cheaper and easier. And Hillary bombed Belgrade with depleted uranium. She basically ran that operation. And then she sits back and sends people to die in these corrupt, illegal military operations. She stands down in Benghazi, and the media acts like she's this saint, this goddess. They put ISIS and Al-Qaeda in charge of all these different countries. She is the founder of ISIS, as I said 3 years ago, as Donald Trump said last week. And then they stole the election from Bernie Sanders. If you don't think these people won't kill to maintain their power, think twice. When the controlled media makes jokes about us, pointing out that Hillary is a bloodthirsty killer, it's well known they're Dixie Mafia. It's well known they were CIA. It's all come out. It's well known she threatened Barack Obama repeatedly. These are thugs. It's come out in countless lawsuits. It's come out from the Clinton Foundation. It's come out from their library that they wanted to shut down alternative media. And now Julian Assange, a classical liberal, a real liberal, offered $20,000 reward for info on murdered DC staffer who was a top tech person over emails and an outreach who we pointed out weeks ago when it happened. How suspicious. Chased down, beaten, then shot four times in the back, execution style, wallet, keys, nothing taken. As a message, the people they sent to kill him could have made it look like a robbery. But they didn't. They didn't. They wanted it to be a message, just like Scalia. No autopsy. And then they announced in the Washington Post, oh, he was part of a secret society. Oh, Obama's top guy was there. They want the thinking people to be threatened. They want us to know. So now Assange is basically saying, suggesting murdered DNC staffer Seth Rich was sourced for email attack. That's what Drudge points out. It wasn't the Russians. Assange fingers murdered DNC staffer. Well, of course the Clintons are the prime suspects. But it's not just this guy. Three others. We've played the clips where the guys are on the news filing lawsuits who work for the DNC over Sanders being robbed. What do? You just kill the guy that filed the lawsuit who's a claimant. And notice these are all Democrats. There's a rule with the mafia. Whether these folks know they've joined the mafia or not, when you're in the crew, they see you as their property. And if you violate their operations in any way, they will kill you. And I've always known this historically, metaphysically, but I've also been told this. You're really smart, Jones. Never take big corporate money or political money or to ever get involved with any of these people officially in, you know, either party, because then they think they own you. I'm completely independent because there's still some of these old rules that apply where if you completely stay out of their system, then you're just seen almost as like a force of nature that's outside of them, like a wild bear in the woods or something. But if you're in their camp and you ever try to expose corruption, they'll kill you. And they want that message out there. So all you naive Democrats need to understand, nobody kills people like the Democrats in history. Let's play a clip of Julian Assange talking about it last night.
Donald Trump has had a disastrous few weeks. If you look at the polls, he needs a miracle. In the American political lexicon, there's such a thing as the October surprise. The stuff that you're sitting on, is an October surprise in there? Do you even know what you're sitting on?
WikiLeaks never sits on material. Our whistleblowers go to significant efforts to get us material and often very significant risks.
We're going to come back and play the full clip. We're going to come back and play the full clip. And then we're going to get more into this. And then we're going to get into this supposed threat Trump put out where he talked about the Second Amendment being the last resort.
We're on the march.
What he stated.
The empire's on the run.
What he stated.
Alex Jones.
Is fact.
Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo. Americanism, not globalism. Americanism, not globalism.
The era of economic surrender will finally be over.
We will no longer surrender this country or its people to the false song of globalism.
They have gotten the political establishment and the media establishment to become pure, wanton henchmen of totalitarianism.
If you were a foreign power looking to weaken America, you couldn't do better than Hillary Clinton's economic agenda.
I think what the Chinese have done is really smart.
The skyscrapers went up in Beijing and many other cities around the world, while the factories and neighborhoods crumbled right here in Detroit.
It's all training us to accept less, lowering expectations, a post-industrial world, a new dark age. That's what the UN Biological Diversity Assessment 1996 calls for.
When we abandoned the policy of America first, we started rebuilding other countries instead of our own.
Not a world, Winston, that gets more beautiful and more technological and stronger. A world that gets uglier and stupider and more stunted.
That the government should allow Hillary Clinton to become president of the United States.
I voted for Hillary Clinton.
Well, I voted for Hillary. I guess I have to since I'm working for her as well.
You want an image of the future, Winston? It's a boot stomping on a human face forever.
Muslims are peaceful and tolerant people and have nothing whatsoever to do with terrorism.
Women are treated, discriminated against in all of these countries she took money against. Gays and lesbians are either executed or punished severely. They're mistreated. She claims to be their champion.
Don't look at me, Winston, and see the black circles around my eyes and see how ugly and weak I am, expressing myself and dying, and I torture people 18 hours a day, and I have a horrible life. That's the beauty of the satanic evil of the priest of power ripping apart humanity. We're here to hurt humans. We're here to suck your guts out.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance.
Powerful new intro the crew put together, and it tells it like it is. Some folks will hear that quote from 1984 and say, what's Alex talking about? Winston, the top torturer at the Ministry of Love, where they torture you to death, but first brainwash you to submit. Because spiritually, they want to dominate your soul because of the priest of power. And he says, don't look at me being sick and ill and twisted and think that that's a sign of the weakness of the state. No, that's that's a sign of its strength, sucking the soul out of humanity. And you read that in high school, you read that in college, you think this is just too extreme, dystopic. And then you realize this is a guy that experienced that, working as a secret police officer for the British Empire, then as a communist. Then as a BBC propagandist, the Ministry of Truth. And then as a true revolutionary who exposed the whole program. But enough about that. I want to finish up with the Julian Assange situation. in a moment, and this dead tech, high-level tech operative, just like a Snowden, over emails, over outreach, and reportedly Assange is saying, yes, we have a $20,000 reward for info on the murdered DNC staffer, and he's saying, look, yes, it's him. And again, Assange wouldn't know specifically. He would just get some basic data on where it came from. That's why Assange has been saying some stuff comes from the Russians. There's all these governments inside these servers. The scandal is, why are they sharing this data on unencrypted servers? But a lot of this is coming from the inside. And of course, Snowden came from the inside. So many others did. And now the guy's executed. But first, beaten. And then shot four times in the back. And the police in D.C. are saying, nothing to see here, move along, another telltale sign. So what really happened to Seth Rich? Well, we know Hillary likes to kill people. We know she's got a long history of having her henchmen do it. She brags about it. And then her weirdo apologists get up there and act like it's preposterous that this war queen, this torture queen, would be involved in something like this when it could bring her down and the entire crime syndicate of the communist Chinese, the Saudi Arabians, and others she represents. Here's Julian Assange last night.
Donald Trump has had a disastrous few weeks. If you look at the polls, he needs a miracle. In the American political lexicon, there's such a thing as the October surprise. The stuff that you're sitting on, is an October surprise in there?
We
do you even know what you're sitting on?
WikiLeaks never sits on material. Our whistleblowers go to significant efforts to get us material and often very significant risks. As a 27-year-old who works for the DNC, who was shot in the back, murdered just 2 weeks ago for unknown reasons as he was walking down the street in Washington. So
That was just a robbery, I believe, wasn't it?
No, there's no finding. So
hit pause. Back it up 5 seconds, please. German television and German print is some of the most controlled in the world. In fact, it just came out a few months ago where some of the top newspaper editors said, look, we're told to say what we say by the CIA daily. Don't blame us. And, of course, Dutch TV, just all of it is so incredibly state-run. This is Dutch TV, but it's just as bad. And it makes the head spin. To go, Donald Trump will need a miracle to win with all these fake polls they've got. I mean, we know they're fake. We have the methodology. You add 10 to 15 points, more Democrats into your sample than Republicans. They shouldn't be polling like that. They should be going out in the streets. They should be hitting people up via email. They should be going on social networks and randomly picking people and then questioning them. But that they do it with landlines, with phone numbers and databases. They know what results they're going to get. And let me explain something. I've paid for 5 or 6 polls myself. You can read the news articles about them over the years. And I would contact Zogby, Reuters, Mason-Dixon, Gallup, you name it. And the cheapest poll you could get was like $10,000. And I would say straight questions. I'd say, I want just a straight demographic, because you have to check off all these boxes and talk to them on the phone for hours. And I want to ask them just simple questions. And they would go, how about we ask it like this? And always change it to basically take my money, but then push some agenda that they separately had with their corporate supporters and corporate donors. That's how polls work. It's very hard to get real polling numbers. That's why you've got to hire top pollsters and have your own internal polls. Not to tell you what you want to hear, but to know you can't go with the mainline polls. So there's internal polling that governments and corporations do, and they've got it via Google and Facebook and Twitter. They've all got their databases. And then they've got the fake polls for the public. And basically, they're all fake. People go, oh, look at the Drudge poll. You know, it lets you vote once, but people can go to other devices or whatever. And, oh, look, remember Hillary Clinton got like 2% and Jeb Bush got like 2% and Bernie Sanders of the Democrats was getting like 70%. And so was Trump, I mean, I'm giving you a gestalt. There were a bunch of those polls. But Hillary never got above single digits. That's more indicative where 2 million people go vote on a poll and no one cares enough to get Hillary Clinton up above 10% or Jeb Bush up above 2 to 4%, depending on which time they did the poll. The most unscientific are the most scientific because the scientific ones are completely gamed like a $3 bill. But I'm going to stop right there. Dutch TV, German TV, even when RT has them on, they don't get to the hard questions with Assange. And it's like, oh, he was robbed, the guy shot in the back. Oh, he was really, Trump's going to lose. I mean, the whole thing is pitched like this. Let's continue.
It's a robbery, I believe, wasn't it?
No, there's no finding. So
what are you suggesting? What are you suggesting?
I'm suggesting that our sources take risks and they become concerned to see things occurring like that.
But was he one of your sources then? I mean,
we don't comment on who our sources are.
But why make the suggestion about a young guy being shot in the streets of Washington?
Because we have to understand how high the stakes are in the United States and that our sources are...
Hit pause again, please. Yeah. And then just back it up 5 seconds. This so-called anchor is just salivating to jump in and ridicule. Oh, this young guy shot in the street. He didn't even have a name now. He's not a top DNC staffer over tech. He's not the outreach individual. There haven't been other deaths. He's just some guy. He's just shot in the street in D.C. I mean, come on, Assange. And Assange is like, do you understand the climate? Do you understand the stakes? Remember, Assange sits there for hours a day reading all this classified stuff, all the horrible stuff, the torture, the secret police, the horrible evil, what information he says will bring Hillary down, which he better release quick. And you've got this salivating sycophant not even hiding his impartiality. You know, in the Netherlands, it's a state secret what the Dutch royal family's even worth. That's how controlled their press is, but the public there thinks it's open and free. There are none so blind as those who have eyes but yet cannot see. To quote the good book, let's finish the clip.
And that our sources are, you know, our sources face serious risks. That's why they come to us, so we can protect their anonymity.
But it's quite something to suggest a murder. That's basically what you're doing.
Well, that others have suggested that we are investigating to understand what happened in that situation with Seth Rich. I think it is a concerning situation. There's not a conclusion yet. We wouldn't be willing to state a conclusion, but we are concerned about it. And more importantly, a variety of WikiLeaks sources are concerned when that kind of thing happens.
Now, let's expand on this. We have heard from 30, 40, it's got to be more than that, world leaders, political pundits, political candidates calling for the execution or murder, assassination in the field of Mr. Snowden. Now, Hillary is a globalist operative. Do you think they want to kill somebody that's going to leak the fact that they directed the theft of the election from Bernie Sanders? That's what was leaked to Julian Assange. That's what he already released in part one. Who do you think has their hands on that? Who do you think would see that? A Bernie Sanders supporter in the DNC that witnesses the fraud, witnesses the orders, and sends it to Assange, and then within 1 week of it being out, is gunned down. But he's just some guy. This is a big, big deal. We need to look more into the death of Seth Rich. There's a $20,000 reward, obviously, taking place so that hopefully that will spur some interest outside of the quarters that actually care about living in a free and open society to some extent. But the trail of carnage behind Hillary, can you imagine what it's going to be like if she gets in with all the things that are happening in this world, especially with all of her cognitive problems that are clearly rearing their ugly head? Now, you see this climate of censorship. You see this climate of intimidation, the climate of going after whistleblowers, the climate of persecuting and imprisoning members of the press at a level never before seen in U.S. history. And then we see the media becoming more and more lapdog, sending their questions to Hillary, to Obama, getting pre-approval, being given scripts of what to say, being given scripts on who to attack, being given directives and daily talking points from Media Matters, run by the White House on who to go after and what to do. This is organized crime. Media Matters said, we will infiltrate media organizations from within. We will bring them down. You've just seen Roger Ailes out in a three-year program. They waited to before the election so that Fox has now been taken completely over, so that they won't challenge a stolen election. This is systematic. And you'd have to be blind and deaf and dumb not to know it. And so many fools say to me, oh, Alex, don't you feel great? Fox News' ratings are imploding. It's turning into the Clinton News Network. Your ratings are exploding. Oh, my gosh. Aren't you excited? And I'm like, absolutely not. Fox wasn't perfect, but it was still pro-Second Amendment and things like that. It's being fully taken over and destroyed in front of us. They're taking down the big lead elephant first that was there to control conservatives, but still had some real people in it the system didn't like. This is a coup. You get rid of it first. Rush Limbaugh, Matt Drudge, Alex Jones, Michael Savage. I know Savage doesn't like Hannity, and I've had problems with Hannity, but at this point, they're coming after everybody who is not out to get America. So the citizens better support Infowars.com and other platforms and spread the word and spread the links and spread Infowars.com/show with the free video and audio feeds. And don't take it for granted. I know you're not, but this is a war, and you're just as important as we are. And I get mad at myself every day. I'm skipping this network break. That I do not express to you enough or in a hardcore enough fashion how it's 2 minutes to midnight, baby. And all the signs are there. The globalists are making their moves. They just sold over $1 billion more of high-tech weapons to Saudi Arabia yesterday. Saudi Arabia is running proxy wars all over the Middle East. They're running wars against Russia and bragging 2 years ago to Russia, we're going to hit you in your borders. This is a very dangerous time to be alive, folks. Russia's response was to basically be invited in to Syria. Russia said, oh, you just threatened us? Boom, we're going to openly come in. It's a bad situation getting worse with a weird woman who's clearly got neurological problems and who brags about killing people in public. The people that actually do the killing don't brag about it. It is the worst thing you can do, and it is the worst luck as well. And I'm just telling you, ladies and gentlemen, that this is out of control. And I know you know that. We need your support now more than ever. I want to be able to not run around all day trying to raise money and, quite frankly, having to mess with sponsors and get them all approved and make sure they're the very best and jack with it. I'd rather just sell great products I know that we've tested that are the best out there at the lowest prices in a win-win to fund this operation so I can get the camera crew, the more reporters, more people in the field, and take action. We have a Get Off the Grid mega special that's only running through Sunday. It's silver bullet, super high quality, 30 parts per million colloidal silver. 50% off at $19.95. It's probably the lowest price you're going to find out there for this quality. Now it's $9.95. I'm calling it the Black Friday level special in August. It's Black Friday special in August, really. Silver Bullet is super concentrated to three times the dose of normal colloidal silver and is the highest quality out there. Silver Bullet stores for years. It's perfect for preparedness supply. whether it's economic meltdown or any other collapse, experts admit coil silver is essential to have on hand. Get Silver Bullet 50% off at InfoWarsLife.com before we sell out. That's InfoWarsLife.com. And you can go read the five-star reviews. This is from Sether in Dallas-Fort Worth, Texas. DFW. Alex and InfoWars store deliver the goods again. This is the highest quality coil silver I have tried. While there are many other silver products available, the InfoWars Silver Bullet offers a strong and effective PPM, which I've found to work remarkably well in treating ear infections and in strengthening my immune system. This is a tremendously affordable colloidal silver and is ideal for budget-minded InfoWarriors. Grab a bottle of your medicine cabinet and a couple for your bug-out bag. You just go on and read hundreds and hundreds of five-star reviews. And again, this is the best-selling colloidal silver in the country. It's the same one that Whole Foods private labels. It's a huge facility. It's the highest quality. It's like lightning in a bottle when they make it. And that's why it keeps so long compared to others. And it is just essential. It's totally essential. I personally stockpile it because if things really break down and antibiotics and things aren't available, it's not a silver bullet, but it's darn close. And I've had cases where antibiotics don't work, and boy, they're a godsend, aren't they? It's just this is what Mother Nature gave us. Obviously, consult your healthcare provider or physician before you use colloidal silver, and obviously follow the recommendations there. I personally, with family, have gone nuclear before when people were dying in the family from infections, and my dad was in bed for a month, and I personally dumped three bottles down him in 1 week. He said, this could hurt my kidneys, and I said, damn right, you're not dying, drink it. They knocked it out. Three rounds of super hardcore antibiotics didn't help him. Killed my uncle, killed my cousin, whatever this super bug was that everybody was getting in Texas. It was in the local news. And that's my personal story of what happened. I had the same stuff. Folks, when you use something like that and you're coughing up blood, I was taking the antibiotics. They were injecting me in the butt with them. And I was taking normal dosages of colloidal. I myself drank two bottles in 3 days, and it... And my pee was green. I'm sure it wasn't good for me. The point is that all these antibiotics are poisons, folks. All right? But that's why the ancients all ate off silver platters and silver cutlery, because it was associated with health. And low dosages, obviously, from my research, are excellent for you. But I don't normally get into colloidal silver and actually break down why I believe in it, why I love it, why some people swear by it, why the system. And by the way, they tried it over a decade ago. This is a news story, not even a plug now. To shut down colloidal silver and silver products, you failed. You go to Walgreens, you go to CVS, it's like whole aisles. You go to hospitals now, they've got sprays of it. They're putting all over everywhere because the iodine quit working. Iodine's great too. We have that. The other super antibiotics quit working, folks. And you know what? Silver might stop working. I mean, you know, we're running out of options here. Number one cause of death in this country now is drug-resistant bacteria and crap that they're just shipping in at record levels, and I take it personal. That Obama ships in millions of people, unvetted, hundreds of thousands with TB, you name it, and then people are just dying all over the place, and it's just all covered up. Anyways, they tried to shut it down, and they failed. The genie's out of the bottle. The silver bullet is now known. And so all this is the number one factory, number one cleanest. I mean, you think I'm going to sell something with the way the government is? I'm not going to go out and find the cleanest, best, super certified folks at Whole Foods get theirs from? Exactly. So about a third of our products are private labeled, just number one bestsellers in the world, and we just sell them for a little bit less. And then the others are game changers, like DNA Force, absolute insane asylum game changer. I mean, it's just so incredible. And I'm so mad at myself, I keep forgetting to take it every day. When I take it every day, it is just, it's amazing. My dad, my mom, they're like, what is going on? You look younger. What do you? I take the DNA Force, sweetheart. My dad developed it and forgets to take it, but he sure looks good after he's been on this. I'm telling you, folks, the BioPQQ alone is amazing. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com. We've got solar panel control units and solar panels that are off right now. Huge discounts. We've got water filters 20% off. InfoWars solar base station power supply 33% off. InfoWarsStore.com and so much more. And by the way, this just shows how the internet's gamed by trolls sometimes. This is an item you don't sell a lot of. And so we use third-party sites, so it's not us. So it's the only one of the products we have that has a, you know, 2-star review. And we go in there, all the real certified buyers give it 4 to 5 stars, but then there's trolls giving it 0 stars. So that it creates the illusion. But see, we've got to use outside third parties. So that's just, you know, instead of you getting, you know, the truth of how great it is, you're going to get their lies. That's how they target us. That's how they work so hard against us. So I was thinking about folks that have bought the unit. You ought to shoot video of it, put it on YouTube or send it to us, you know, if you want to be a testimonial of how you're using the solar panels. We just went out and found out what had the best reviews, what people liked, what had the best scientific systems, you know, what had the lasted the longest. And I'm always telling folks, hey, we've been selling this for a year. Is there something better that we can get in bulk to sell? So it's like the little power station deal that's the size of a brick. Or it's a lot smaller than a brick, but about this length and width of a brick, but not as thick as a brick. And it'll jump your car 12 times on one charge, run all these different devices. I mean, it's just a godsend. And the technology just gets better and better. Now, in a year, we'll probably be selling something else that comes out that's better. But we bought thousands of these, and they're $99 right now. I mean, you can't even get these on Amazon for that because we private labeled them. And it's just great technology, and it funds the operation. It helps us get the job done here. So I want to thank you all for going and checking that out. I want to thank you if you have gotten the products, if you have purchased them, at InfoWarsStore.com, because that's how we fund this operation. We also have 40% off extended to the weekend on Anthroplex. We've never done that. So these are basically Black Friday in August specials. Nobody else is doing it now. We're doing it now. Now, I'm going to start the next hour, and I'm going to get into these clips where Joe Biden said basically the exact same thing that Trump said about the Second Amendment, and the media is basically covering that up. We're also going to get into the huge open borders news, the gigantic economic news, and so much more. Open the phones up and have a special guest on. I'm Alex Jones with InfoWars.com. And if you're watching or listening to this transmission, you are the resistance. All right. We got the new national controversy to show how violent, how evil Donald Trump is. Of course, remember, it was 4 or 5 months ago in Chicago that they sent Hillary operatives dressed as Bernie Sanders reporters. That's now been confirmed by the WikiLeaks emails from the DNC to attack Trump supporters to create the narrative Debbie Wasserman Schultz was writing that Sanders people are violent and Donald Trump people are violent. Now, that's what Roger Stone at the time said his sources in Chicago told him. And, of course, those sources were the police department because they were monitoring the whole thing. And even for a leftist police department, their mouths were hanging open watching this. But continuing, now it's Donald Trump, ladies and gentlemen. He wants to basically have gun owners in America overthrow the election if Hillary gets in. That's not what he said. He made the classic statement that if all else fails and they try to overthrow our Bill of Rights and Constitution, we have a right to defend against it with the Second Amendment. That's what the Declaration of Independence states, that if the central government becomes destructive of our rights, it is our duty, not just our right, to stand up against it. And that's how this country got founded when they came to take the guns in 1775. And that's why they're trying to demonize in law schools and academia the Declaration of Independence and trying to list it now as an extremist terrorist document along with the Gadsden flag, because it tells you what you already know. If we have foreign multinationals that have hijacked the country running everything, that have taken it over, we have a right and a duty to at some point physically stand up. We don't want to do that. We're making inroads politically. We're changing things. They've got Black Lives Matter and communist groups out openly trying to start a race war and an anti-cop war. I mean, this is on record. So we don't want to go down that road. They're the ones that are violent. But when they try to blame Donald Trump, it's a fraud. So first, let's play the clip of Trump. Then we're going to play Biden and then Hillary. But here's what Trump said yesterday that got the media so upset.
If she gets to pick her judges, nothing you can do, folks. Although the Second Amendment people, maybe there is, I don't know. But
he just mildly hinted at what everybody from G. Gordon Liddy to Alex Jones has said in the last 20 years. I mean, that's the old statement from 100 years ago. Well, if all else fails, we got the Second Amendment. States on the East Coast have the right to revolt, like in New Hampshire, in their Bill of Rights. But let's go ahead now and go to Biden saying, he comes after my Beretta, he's going to have a problem because I'm good with it. Talking about Obama, here it is.
I got two. If he tries to fool my Beretta, he's got a problem. I like a little over and under. You know, I'm not bad with it.
Now, let's go in a moment to this clip as we get ready to go out to break of Hillary. That was 2008 with Biden. This is Hillary in 2008 as well, basically threatening Obama. Here it is.
My husband did not wrap up the nomination in 1992 until he won the California primary somewhere in the middle of June, right? We all remember Bobby Kennedy was assassinated in June in California. I don't understand it. And, you know, there's lots of speculation about why it is, but...
What's your speculation?
I don't know.
All right, that's her talking about Obama. So a clear threat compared to what Trump said, and this just shows the bias. I tend to have a governor on my mind where I don't say things as sensationally as reality is. And I walked in there where Kit Daniels just churned out a real quick, great article pointing out the hypocrisy of Joe Biden in 2008 saying, look, I got two guns. I got two Berettas. And if Obama tries to take my guns, we're going to play the clip in a moment. You know, he's going to have a problem because I got a gun. I mean, he clearly is threatening Obama. This is when they were running together, and it's to conservative crowds, blue-collar folks, that, hey, you don't worry. Nobody wants your rifle, your shotgun, your handgun. Nobody, because that's the full quote. Obama wants to get mine, he's going to have to take it away, and I got two of them, and I know how to use it. Then Trump comes out and simply says, they're going to have the courts, they're going to have everything, they're going to take your guns, and then there's nothing you can do about it. I mean, maybe Second Amendment folks might do something, but I don't know. I mean, saying, hey, what do you do? And they turn that into he's threatening Hillary and threatening Obama and threatening violence. This has got to go viral. So I went in there and I said, you know what? You got the headline right. Biden threatens Obama with a gun in 2008, yet media attacks Trump over guns. He's probably even linked in the headline. This needs to go viral right now. We've got the clips right there. We need to take this clip out of the show right now from the start of this segment and add it in just to give people some basic commentary here on how crazy this is. Then we have the clip of Hillary saying, hey, I'm not out of the race. You know, Robert Kennedy got killed when he was in the lead in California, talking about Obama. I mean, you could clearly say that was a threat. Coming from the Clintons, you know it was. Then the big boys at Bilderberg met in Virginia. We were there covering it. No other media would cover it. It later admitted they were in a secret meeting there deciding she would step down. That's how people get basically installed as nominees now. The big boys, the big girls in the big time. They should be in the big house, but, oh, and they pray to a big God, don't they? To quote Peter Gabriel. Because they're big time. At our expense, and they decided the nominees are. And then along comes Donald Trump getting zero big money, zero big pharma. Defense contractors aren't giving any money because they got a dossier, they got a file, they got a profile, they got to look into old Donald Trump, and they know he loves God's creations. He loves family, he loves green grass. He loves red meat, and he loves beautiful women. And to death lovers, that don't look too good. Trump likes prosperity. Trump likes a big, juicy cornucopia. Trump's not out to get anybody. He's out to prove to other powerful people he's the alpha dog, though, and they don't like that. He wants to dominate alphas. He wants to dominate so-called controllers. Twisted alphas. They got his number, and they're scared. So let's play those clips one more time. Here's what Biden said in 2008 while he was out lying to their constituents that they'd never come after our guns and that he'd be ready to take up arms against Obama if he tried. Here it is.
I got two. If he tries to fool my Beretta, he's got a problem. I like that little over and under. You know, I'm not bad with it.
Yeah, and there's a full clip. I know that's off the NRA tweet. We've got it because it's in Fall the Republic. We have the full clip where he just runs around talking about Obama for like 5 minutes. And you're not getting my rival. You're not getting my shotgun. You're not getting my Beretta. You better watch it. Here's part of the full clip.
I guarantee you, Barack Obama ain't taking my shotguns. So don't buy that malarkey. Don't buy that malarkey. They're gonna start peddling that to you. I got two. If he tries to fool my Beretta, he's got a problem. I like that little over and under. You know, I'm not bad with it.
And then if you get the full clip, they're not getting the handguns. They're not getting the rifles. They're not getting none of it. It's all a right-wing lie. Here we are 8 years later, 7.5 years later, and then there, New York Times, Associated Press, Rolling Stone. It's time to repeal the Second Amendment. Take them all. Matt Damon, take them all. Dianne Feinstein, Barbara Boxer, Mr. and Mrs. America. If I had the votes, I'd ban every gun right now. Turn them all in. And these people don't think we have attention spans or remember this. But here's the issue. You just threatened Barack Hussein Obama. But you were his VP running mate. It was all a carefully crafted script you gave to hundreds of speeches. Just like you said you can keep your doctor and Obamacare is free. And then we never said that. Tell him, Gruber.
Actually, you hired me to lie to everyone. And you said my lies were best.
Let's go to the State Department spokesman. Hey, college kids. You're going to learn how to screw everybody? Here, let's go to Donald Trump yesterday in the hissy fit.
If she gets to pick her judges, nothing you can do, folks. Although the Second Amendment people, maybe there is, I don't know. But...
So there you go. And I know I've harped on this now off and on the last hour and 15 minutes quite a bit, but it's a huge, gigantor deal. I'm not even going to play the Hillary clip again. We're going to post it in Kit Daniels' article, but it needs to go viral. We're putting it on Facebook, Twitter. We need to get this out to everyone. We need to take the last 10 minutes of this show, clip it in with the same headline as the article and just hammer them. And when you guys decide, when you gals decide to actually get an article or a video and push it, it becomes a national news story, and we put them back on their heels. What I'm saying is we have logic and memories here, nothing special, but they seem to be in short supply. We will build the videos and the articles with the truth, nothing but the truth, their own words. We will lay out the weapons for you in the information war. If you send them out in your emails, if you put them on your Facebook and Twitter, if you make YouTube videos about it, if you send it to local talk show host, I don't even want the credit. Just host, play the clips, point out the hypocrisy. When people follow our talking points that don't come from Media Matters or the White House or the CIA, they come from Nico and Matt and Daria and other folks going, remember Biden said that. He said that about the Beretta. Oh, yeah, and didn't Hillary make a threat? Yeah, get the clips. That's the talking point. Just citizens that are paying attention, getting together with a media platform, unfiltered to bring this to you. And it's the reason I get so frustrated is that I've got dozens and dozens of these things a day, and I can only get one or two that go viral to counter these people. If we were countering them on every level, we would destroy them. I'm going to explain something again. They admit that Media Matters has almost no traffic. People go, oh, look, it's pathetic. You know, you're 10,000 times more traffic. I mean, check it out, according to Google and Alexa, than Media Matters. Why do you care about them? Because it's the White House runs it. The former transition chief runs it. They meet multiple times a week at the White House. They've called for ending the free press in America. They've called for shutting down our operations. They've called for infiltrating media organizations from within. This is a saboteur organization, an intelligence operation. And what they say within hours is on CNN, MSNBC, ABC, all of it, with word for word. See what we are? We, and by the way, Media Matters gets this. This is what they harp on. They go, Jones is creating talking points for Congress and foreign governments. It's spreading from Russia to Syria to Germany to the UK. And I meet with UKIP's head. He goes, yes, 15 years ago, as we started to get bigger, and I was coming on your show, we would knock on doors. And the majority of people had heard about UKIP, not from the UK press, but from InfoWars. We were already big back then. And this isn't about being big. I'm skipping another break. I'll just shut all ads down soon. I'm serious. You have to understand, it's not me here bragging that 15 years ago, we basically helped give the oxygen that UKIP needed just with our audience in the UK. You, the listeners in the UK, spreading the word. I was told this by Nigel Farage at dinner over a glass of red wine. Roger Stone is so funny. He keeps stuff so secret. We were there at dinner. He had a little private meeting with Farage. I did too. And we were having dinner at this restaurant. And then when he comes on and talks about it, he goes, I know you had dinner with him. And I had dinner too. But he doesn't even get into those stories because it was not an off the record meeting, but it was, you know, not on the record, as you'd say. But Farage, you know, also talked to our crew and the rest of it. And he's come on the show and talked about how the majority of UKIP folks that he first discovered knocking on doors had heard about it from InfoWars. I'm just telling you, that was 15 stinking years ago. We were already having a huge effect, and I didn't even understand it then. I wish I would have known. I would have had the responsibility to work even harder because I wasn't thinking that big back then. I was just simply trying to show folks what was going on, hoping other people who were smarter than I was would organize the information and take the New World Order on. Turned out nobody did it. So we just get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and the New World Order is looking at me, and it's not fun. It's not like, oh, I'm getting really huge. Boy, we're the zeitgeist in the world. Boy, with Drudge like nitrous oxide in our race car, we're going to the next level. It's not fun going 300 miles an hour. But you know what? It's a good thing. But I'm just letting you inside my mind on how we're fighting and how we need you and how you've already stood up. That's why you've changed the world. You are incredible. You are amazing. You are the info war. You are the strength. You are why we're having such a big effect. And suddenly there are other groups and organizations understanding the paradigm. It's shifting. It's taking place. And it's really worrying the globalists, and that is so exciting because they wanted to have this worldwide collapse and this clash of civilizations jihad event without the public being aware. They wanted to hit us in the dark where they've got the cultural, scientific, technocracy, night vision like the owl, and we don't have the night vision. Well, guess what? InfoWars isn't their Luciferian night vision. I'm not saying literal night vision is Luciferian. It's an allegory, folks. It's other archetypes, the owl. It sees in the dark. You can't. But we basically have little independent media spotlights. And more of them are popping up. And more light. And then we're seeing the owls for what they are all around us. And the globalists are crapping their britches. Sorry for the crudeness, but that, you know, when the allegory fits, that's it. When the parallel fits. When the shoe fits. And so just don't underestimate how much trouble the New World Order's in. Don't underestimate. Because, I mean, Nigel Farage was on the show like 6-7 years ago and said, I've got to tell you, Alex, you know, many or most of the homes I knock on are your listeners, and they found out about UKIP from you, so thank you. But then he's telling you face-to-face that. And then other political people tell you the same thing. And it's unbelievable that we even underestimated the effect we were having, that you were having. So they're coming after our free speech. They're coming after your free speech. But they've got a bunch of White House operatives feeding the media through Media Matters as a fence. And also direct emailing the media, telling them what to do. That's now come out. And people are dying because it's coming out. And I just want to ask the folks at Media Matters and everywhere else, you understand you're going to end up going down with the ship now. When the murders come out and all the corruption and the grand juries, and there's a very good chance that we're seeing a counter coup in this country against your coup, and that a lot of you are going to be in deep trouble. And I don't take any pleasure out of that because a lot of you just kind of got caught up on the bandwagon, but you better look in the mirror. I mean, do you want to be involved with dead staffers that had a conscience? Do you really want to be involved? But look, you're going to make your decision. I'd say between you and God, but you don't believe in God. Your bosses do. They want folks working for them that don't. Think about that for a minute. But I'm telling you from the bottom of my heart, if you are an info warrior, I don't care if you live in Africa or Asia or the Middle East or Europe or Latin America, it doesn't matter. When you just analyze things, when you just point things out, when you just use common sense, when you videotape something locally that happened or analyze local news and put it on the web, you are overturning their artificial intelligence, their globalist system. You are overpowering it. You are defeating it. And so every action you take, every exertion you engage in is so massive because together we can move mountains. Many hands make light work, and we have the truth on our side. And InfoWars is here to analyze common sense and put out talking points that aren't centralized. I don't have to tell my crew what talking points are. I hire people that have common sense and see something for what it is. See, that's the difference between a centralized system and a decentralized system. I would have people on the show that disagree. They won't come on. They can't debate. Because they're anti-intellectuals, pretending that they're intellectuals, pretending that they care about civilization, when all they want to do is go find the biggest, fattest paycheck they can so they can act powerful in front of their friends and family. And here's a dirty little secret for them. When you get down to the end of the line, to the end game, there's not a lot of seats at that table. Oh, there were lots of seats early on to sell out America and sell out the West and go along with globalism. But when you get down to the final few rounds, as the planet's free culture circles the drain, you're going to be thrown to the wayside. You're going to be forgotten. You're going to be used up and thrown away. If you had any common sense in your mind, you would join with liberty, join with freedom, join with the cornucopia of liberty and open markets. But instead, you worship the flame of tyranny. You just think you're powerful because you're close to it. But even those that are within the flame of power itself realize they are the greatest slaves of all. There is nothing out there better than taking care of your family and farming and being a decent person or working in a wood shop or being an artist and really just caring about the universe and trying to be a good, decent person versus all these weak, twisted people that are scrabbling and telling you they're the intellectuals and telling you they're the artists and telling you they have all the answers and telling you talk like they want and use the words they want and do what they say and be guilty and be quiet and don't take risks. And the nanny state, they want you bound so they can march around and feel like God's above you. They're not bringing in giant, unwashed, diseased, desperate hordes of humanity to help them. The globalists have carried out every policy they could to create that atmosphere. Now they use our Christian Western guilt against us and bring in populations fundamentally incompatible and then twist their minds into a socialist template to complete the fall of the West. Because in the heart of the Renaissance is the defeat of tyranny. And they're just getting rid of the final opposition to that before they really start tearing stuff up. Mark Faber issues stunning warning that a gigantic 50% stock market crash could be coming. We'll talk about this with Steve Quayle coming up. Sunday Express, we should nationalize German banks, warning Deutsche Bank teetering on edge of crisis, top economist says. Sell as monetary policy is a dead duck, bond analyst, CNBC. Shock, Americans' wages dropping fast in 2016. Is the government making money off your student loans? You bet they are. Google's latest moonshot, it's soaring stock. That's the real economy, folks. That's what's really going on. And then on top of that, look at this we're going to talk about with Steve Quayle when we come back. France 24. Panama agrees to help migrants head on to the U.S. It's coordinated and run by the U.N. I told you this years ago, but now here it is. Coordinated. Run. Third world doesn't want them to stop. Their country, come here. 24-year-old refugee and ISIS member arrested in Germany for planning to bomb football stadium. Gangs in Chicago reportedly agree to use snipers, automatic weapons against the police. Fears of a callousness in Italy as migrants keep flooding across the Mediterranean. The new Germany, Switzerland struggles to cope with surge of migrants trying new route. It's not safe in Germany anymore. German family flee to Russia to claim asylum. The media kind of makes a joke out of this. These people have jobs. They're Christians. They don't want to be forcibly inoculated. If you actually read their full statements, they just say Germany is now satanic. And the Russians, of course, aren't letting them in. Saying, oh, no, Germany's a very nice country. Continuing, the Olympic diving pool turns green. Well, that's okay. They told folks just... there's so much sewage and stuff, you just need to close your mouth when you swim. It's all coming up and more. I'm Alex Jones, Infowars.com. Spread that website.
We're on the march.
They want to censor it. Don't let them. Alex, human power overpowers the technocracy. We have Biden. What's so crazy about all of this? Saying, hey, don't worry, we're not coming after your guns. If Obama ever tries to come after any of our guns, I've got my guns and I know how to use them and I'll basically fight back. That was an extreme crazy statement, but see, it was meant to make gun owners go to sleep, so it was okay. Now, again, I just wanted to show people CNN where it was talking about how it's a firestorm and all this stuff. It was like 5 minutes ago. It's not a big deal. But they're coming for the Second Amendment. You can bet your bottom dollar that they have admitted that that's what they're doing, and they are now pushing it whole hog in all these big newspapers, admitting they want our guns, admitting that they are coming for our guns. And so we're just supposed to sit here and watch her steal the primary and then have all these fake polls, which we know are fake, and then install her so they can continue their lawlessness. Total and complete lawlessness. And now, oh, Trump went ahead of her 10 points, and then she went ahead of him 12 points, and now they're within 1 point. Fox polls, CNN polls, on and on and on to make you think the polls are accurate, and you go into all these polls, they'll just throttle back the margin of Democrats they're talking to from 65% to, say, 55 to make it look close, and then throttle it back up. And then on election day, they want it to be believable. And Wired's got a big breakdown. The polls are all wrong. A startup called it our best hope to fix them. A startup called Civis. Well, we'll look into that. The point is that if you look at the indications, the indicators of what's happening in social media, Donald Trump has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times the traffic. Always more traffic than Hillary, but it goes from double to 10 times to even higher, whether it's on YouTube or Facebook or Google or any of these places. And that's with all the governorship and censorship they're engaged in. We're going to go until the end of the next hour to Steve Quayle, talk show host in his own right, best-selling author, trailblazer when it comes to analyzing the New World Order. And boy, I tell you, he was on the show 5 years ago saying they're going to try to start a race war in this country, talking about all the different plans, a plan to start killing police and military. And on air, I'd say, Steve, come on, it's not that bad. They wouldn't try something like that. And I'll say he's been really accurate. Sometimes he's thought it's coming a little bit sooner than it is, but he's been spot on, like with the fact that they have military drones practicing and targeting U.S. homes. He said that 3 years before it was in the Associated Press. So we're going to be talking to Steve Quayle here in just a moment. Before I do that, I want to encourage the listeners here today to support the broadcast. This is real independent media that's not playing games, that flies by the seat of its pants when it comes to funding. And we run a lot of specials on really high-quality products to be able to fund ourselves. I appreciate your support, your patronage. You could not be putting money in a better place if you're against globalism and want to stop the New World Order. When we sell our colloidal silver, silver bullet, highest quality 30 parts per million from the biggest, most respected lab in the United States, it's about $5 off what the competition sells it for. When we sell it for $9.95, 50% off only a few times a year, this is an insanely good loss leader deal. Get it today at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And it's great to buy for friends and family, you name it. And if you don't know why colloidal silver is good, well, just go do your own research. Look at all of the drug-resistant garbage in this country now. Look at how antibiotics more and more aren't working. And folks, I'm not saying it's a total silver bullet, but it's as close as you get to that. And I'm not saying you should take this in lieu of antibiotics. Consult your physician. I know that when I am really sick and antibiotics aren't working, I go to colloidal silver. I got to the point now where I go to colloidal silver first. It almost always knocks it out. If it doesn't, I go to antibiotics. So this is, do your own research. I'm just a layperson breaking down why the ancients believed in silver. I mean, everybody knows this. Why in every culture, silver was seen as warding off evil. Folks knew it had amazing properties. Too much of it's poisonous. That's why we've got the big national group that puts it out at what is believed to be, you know, the safest but also most effective dose of true 30 parts per million. We also have 20% off on all Alexa Pure water filtration systems. With all the garbage in the water table, you're insane if you're not filtering your water. We have a bunch of different brands of great gravity-fed systems there, and Alexa Pure is excellent. We have the InfoWars solar base station and power control system that is the very best unit for the price you're going to find out there, has the best technologies in it, lasts the longest, gives you the most conversion. I mean, I've had tech heads, people that are into solar systems, look at it and go, wow, that's a really great unit you're selling, really low price. Well, yeah, I went to experts, and it took me 5 years to finally find a unit that we thought was excellent and you know, really worked good, and we could also get it at a good price. So we could sell it at a good price. And we're looking at other brands and stuff. Other stuff's coming online. We may have more choices soon. That's how we operate. We just go out and find the best thing we can and sell it at the lowest prices. We've got a lot of other preparedness items that are 50 to 20% off today at InfoWarsStore.com. Be sure and go check that out and take advantage of it. Now, shifting gears, I want to ask Steve Quayle of stevequayle.com, one of the original preppers, one of the original patriots in America, 25 plus years on air, one of the first people I interviewed when I got on air 21 years ago, where he thinks the Trump revolution's going, what he thinks of Brexit. Are these not good signs of an awakening? I know on top of that, horrible global government, horrible economic numbers, forced inoculations, open borders, TB pouring across, jihadis pouring across. I want to ask him, what is the state of the world right now? What is he most focused on? What is he most concerned about? He also has hosted TV shows. He has a new amazing DVD film out we'll be telling you about in the next hour, TrueLegendsTheSeries.com, SteveQuayle.com. I want to ask Steve Quayle, who saw this, you know, way far off, first got a report on geoengineering, chemtrailing. I'm not kissing his butt. It's true. First guy that I'd get him on because he was interesting, and I knew a lot of stuff he was saying was true. A lot of it was so far out. Human, animal, chimera splicing already going on. I went and searched it, found one BBC article admitting that a decade before it was already happening. So I started going, wow, this guy knows what he's talking about, but why wouldn't they show us the humanzies? Why wouldn't they show us the part human, part cows being produced? Why wouldn't they show us the spider goats? Now they started to. The last decade, until last week, the Associated Press, that's the mouth of Sauron, said, oh, we're splicing humans and animals and raising them inside other animals, and we're going to have all these organs, and they don't have rights because they're part animal, part human. See, this no man's land, everything Steve Quayle wrote about in his genetic Armageddon work and his, all of his books, which a lot of them are out of print. So enough lavishing praise on Mr. Quayle. Steve, let's get into the state of the world, kind of a big picture. From 35,000 feet, then let's zoom in on particulars. But I'm telling you, the nightmare dystopia that you foresaw 25 years ago, it is more and more a reality, spot on, unfortunately. A, how did you know all this? And B, what's the next shoe to drop?
Well, I think, Alex, you know, my perspective when I started on talk radio, 25-plus years ago, was the fact that I began to be a student of prophecy. And the bottom line is the one world government, the one world religion, and the one world economic meltdown, along with the world currency. And we're seeing that all. But you used a word I want to really focus in. Lawlessness is in the land. The cover-up, you know, the situation of four mysterious deaths connected to the DNC in less than a month. And these are the who's who. And how about Bob Bickle calling for the assassination? Now, these are his words, ladies and gentlemen. Just kill this son of a bitch. So those are his words, and Alex is the total breakdown of everything that we used to know was truth, and we're seeing the implementation of total lies. And the total implementation of lies, look, that's what you've been doing. I want to encourage people, support, Alex, support those of us who are out there sounding the alarms. And Alex, right now, it's like we're looking at everything in perspective. We're looking at it retrospect, but it's upon us. When I said on Coast to Coast 20-some years ago, excuse me, that I see civil war, and I warned the police in those days, and I warned the different, even gang members going on record with those over the airwaves, look, you guys, you're going to be used as pawns. And isn't it interesting? The same people that want to take away our Second Amendment are absolutely covering up, you know, the lone gunman, the false flags. You and I have dealt with that for years. How is it that the first reports are always multiple gunmen, and by the time the mainstream vomit brokers get done, it's a single guy, and he's not, out there.
Well, we know there were five people in Nice, France, and they covered that up.
Yep. Yeah, so there's a cover-up. And I want to share something with everybody. Turn the bloody networks off. CNN has always been communist network news, and we're right, Alex, in the middle of a complete communist attempt at takeover and control. Some people don't like to use that word, but you're talking about people as young as 27 years old. Seth Conrad, Rich, what, he's only 27. Then you got John Ash, he's murdered. You got Victor Thorne, who's the author of books exposing the Clintons. And then you've got Sean Lucas, lead attorney for the anti-Clinton DNC fraud. So ladies and gentlemen, when DNC people start being destroyed from within their own group.
And by the way, absolutely, go back to Assange a few weeks ago. He said, this is not the Russians. And now he's saying basically that, yes, this guy was probably his source. He doesn't want to say. But the point is that now he's dead. I mean, this is a serious message. You were the first two when it was only like 50 or something. Now it's like 400 when they started killing all the top microbiologists. I mean, running over them with a van, you know, at the University of Houston and backing back over them, cutting people's heads off, chopping their hearts out, torturing them to death, shooting them, killing their families, all over the world, the microbiologists. Sorry.
No, it was only not only microbiologists, but it was lead virologists, lead immunologists. And here was the deal, Alex. Most people can't still put it together. And now, as you know, it's now natural health practitioners. I think that's 52 or 54 so far. Everyone has got to understand, DNC is openly advocating becoming Murder, Inc., okay? Now, we know you've had Larry on, former Clinton aide, talking about all the deaths under the former Clinton administration. the and present Clinton administration, the inability for a known traitor as Hillary is to basically even be prosecuted tells you how deep the tentacles go into the federal government. And iniquity is abounding. That's absolutely, I'd say, evident to everybody. So let's talk about what the most important things are. I said, and you know this, we've done this in the past, probably a decade ago, that it will be the goal of the New World Order to turn the police against the people and the people against the police. I've even gone on record with a lot of police, law enforcement officers, you know them, I know them, intel guys. I'm saying, look, watch who's in your ranks. Watch who they put into your departments. There's usually hitters, which is means an assassin, and there's also the spies. And Alex, isn't it interesting that there's never any follow-up on who the shooters are, who their relationships were? I'm talking about even the police or even in the BLM, Black Lives Matter, the guys that basically go off and want to kill white people. Well, this is all orchestrated. And by the way, that's been one of the basic tenets of the communist manifesto.
Well, I know a lot of it is orchestrated, I mean, by Soros. And I mean, you were talking about this. I don't want to keep going back to this, but like 15 years ago, and I was like, hey, I'm against the police state, Steve, and blah, blah, blah. And you're like, listen, you don't understand. They're militarizing and globalizing, and then they're going to cause a civil war, wipe out the police, and bring in the multinationals. Now, officially, Strong Cities admits the UN is going to run local police departments.
Right, and also, I think the most critical thing for people to understand is Obama has signed secret executive orders, and I believe, Alex, he's already signed the Articles of Surrender. You cannot put what you talk about day in and day out, all your videos, everything I'm talking about, you can't put it into any other context. You know that not one terrorist training camp, especially of those that are known and watched and monitored and have federal agents in them, has been arrested. They don't even have weapons.
I know. And instead, they tell the FBI they've removed dozens of names like Islamic and Jihad. They can't even ask people that in interrogations. They have literally told them, stand down. We're going to break. I want to ask, cover this in quadrants. The Islamic invasion, 5 million in Europe. We don't know the numbers here. Steve, do you have any idea what the real numbers are? I mean, I know in Austin it's 50 times what they claim.
Right. Well, here's the deal. Everybody can put this into context if they understand that we are under Islamic assault. You've got all the top members in the Obama administration, even in our intelligence and in our Defense Department. Alex, they want World War III. That's why the President of the United States and his whole crew, the neocons plus the neocons on steroids, they want a war with Russia so they can turn the world into a global nuclear meltdown, and that's where their Iman Mahdi comes on the scene. And that's why you can explain everything. You can explain everything that's going on in France, everything that's going on in Britain, everything that's going on in Sweden.
And why would Hillary put the nightclub shooter's dad right behind her in the perfect shot in the vetted area, totally vetted, to send the message that it's time to launch?
It is time to launch. And let me, this is so critical. That was a signal to everyone. Look, let's make it clear. Humadeen, Hillary, you know, they have a relationship that goes beyond politics. I'll be nice. You have a woman who is a mouthpiece for the Muslim Brotherhood. And this is the thing that makes me crazy, Alex. Seriously, why do people not understand?
Stay right
happening?
There, Steve Quayle. Stay there. This is key. And we're coming in with the third hour. We've got to get Steve Quayle on more often. SteveQuayle.com. We'll also, before he leaves, talk about his new DVD film, part of a series, True Legends, series.com. Amazing. I've now had a chance to see it. It's like Discovery Channel quality. We have the State Department spokesman, Mark Toner. I want to play in a moment because Steve was talking about this. This total culture of lying, where whether it's Gibbs getting up and saying, yeah, there is no drone program, even though there is one, I'm telling you there isn't one, and he laughs at you, to Toner, to others. There's this flaunting in criminology. There's this throwing it in your face when they think they're invincible, and this ties into all of it. But I'm telling you, they are trying to destabilize this country and Europe and areas of Asia, Latin America. Brazil is in collapse. Venezuela is in collapse. Areas of Africa are in collapse. And you go research, it's by design. People can pretty much take care of their societies, folks. There's an evil force that wants chaos. And they are saying that Trump wants civil war because he said, you know, we have a Second Amendment to fall back on, when they're the ones pushing that narrative. But I want to play this clip of Mark Toner to get Steve Quayle's response. This is the State Department lead spokesman just last week. And of course, we've been playing it a lot because it's so amazing how arrogant he is. I want Steve's take on it. Here it is.
Welcome to the State Department. I think we have some interns in the back. Welcome. Good to see you in this exercise and transparency and democracy.
Is that what it is?
Sorry,
I thought it was an exercise in spin and obfuscation.
All right. Can you tell us my last briefing?
All right, can you tell us my last briefing? He's just telling you here at the end. Maybe he's a good guy. Hey, we're all a bunch of liars. Can you tell us my last briefing? Maybe he has a soul. Maybe I'm reading it wrong. Then we have this Mateen's father, Omar Mateen's father, right behind Hillary in that vetted area. I mean, that clearly is a message, Steve Quayle.
Well, of course, it's a clear message. And obviously, if you notice, the whole Democratic National Convention, the only people allowed to pray there was, I believe, a Muslim mullah. But here's the bigger picture, Alex. The whole overwhelming of every part of the United States, every border, language, culture, our national symbols, our national anthem, the flag. We knew from the beginning, obviously, from the first years of the president's what I would call reign of terror, T-E-R-R-O-R, that we were going to see the events that he said America's the greatest nation in the country, in the world, and we intend to change all that. Well, what people are watching has changed. And I want to get on to the arming of our enemies. You know, Paul Craig Roberts, in his latest article, said this: now that ISIS is on the verge of total defeat in Syria, Washington's whores among the experts want Russia punished for blocking Washington's overthrow of Syria. Let me make this clear. Every major world government is run by high powered Illuminists. If you watch Hollande, if you watch all these people that line up and stack up against Donald Trump, when I was on Coast to Coast, Donald Trump, and I believe he's the real deal. I've listened to what you've had him on. I've listened to him on Michael Savage. Plus, guess what? When they can't buy you, they first try to insult you, they vilify you, then they try and nullify you, and then they try and destroy you. Well, the point is that if someone's known more by his enemies than his friends, and everything you, Alex, and I have talked about all these decades are obvious for everyone to see, then you got to know that these guys are really worried. And again,
I agree with you, and we're about to go to break. We'll come right back to you. Steve Quayle, cquayle.com is our guest. I'm not going to get an inside baseball, but Trump is for real. He is a patriot, and he's been aware of this stuff for decades, Steve. So he's been a sleeper cell for the Patriots. That's why they're so scared.
Yes, he has. And I think that, you know, I think he's an outstanding human being. You look at his kids, they're just amazing.
And he doesn't want to have war with Russia. He's just a good person. We'll be back in 70 seconds with Steve Quayle. Stay with us. And Steve Quayle, cquayle.com is our guest. TrueLegendsTheSeries.com is the amazing Discovery Channel level quality production based on biblical research and going and around the world and really making some amazing discoveries. No doubt we're being lied to on many, many fronts. We'll talk about that before Steve leaves. And Steve, this is a short segment, long segment coming up. Most of our breaks are at the end and start of an hour, as you know, in talk radio. We've got an old clock from like the 1990s that we stick with. But just in the 5 minutes we have here, let me ask you this question. Your prominence, and we're not, this is not for egos. I know you're basically a recluse, Dr. Pechenik and others, and I get more and more like that because this is our duty. I mean, we're totally in the game, but it's not about being fancy pants here. But what do you think I can do better, or what else should I be doing? Because we've got such a major platform now that since I recently talked to some of the heavy hitters in government and others, and Trump and Nigel Farage, I didn't realize that InfoWars was at the heart of even their own intelligence briefings. So what should we say to these guys, and what should we do?
Well, first of all, you know, standing up for righteousness is always right, and speaking out against evil is really right. You know, even Solomon said, woe unto those who call evil good and good evil, You know, I mean, that's a biblical narrative. But the thing is, Alex, you know, the country is rotting from within. Our foundation. See, this is what you're doing. You're discussing what the country was like. And the problem with most people is they think we still have a Constitution and Bill of Rights. We only have it to the degree we're willing to fight for it. And I say fight in the marketplace of ideas. So when you ask me that, I would tell you this. I think your interview with Steve Pijenik, Dr. Steve Pijenik, was admirable. I don't think people realize that if they're listening to CNN and ABC, CBS, Fox, and all that, that's all vomit brokers. That's why the headlines are the same. They have got to turn that stuff up. I remember when I talked about television sets and television programming basically having infrasonics and
carrier. Now it's putting people into trances. That's now all declassified and admitted.
Yeah, absolutely. So if you want to get the news, look, I got to tell you something. I think the amount of news that's coming out on the alternative networks, and you carry your own stories, and, you know, I think, by the way, I think your investigative journalism, and I don't kiss anybody's butt, okay, is just second.
Well, we have an amazing crew, but I think where you and I and others are, and George Norrie, you name it, are similar is we just take from all the interesting, you know, things and have a real debate. We're not just CNN or Fox. We're here just trying to really fight the globalist. I mean, I think it's because we're mission-oriented.
Well, and you know, what was it? Was it Gehring? Or I think it was Gehring who said, thank goodness for us that people don't think. Well, we're
yes.
trying to get people to think. We're trying to get them involved. We're trying to get them to break away from the iPads, iPods, smartphones, dumb phones, you know. And we talked about all this stuff, mind control. Every single thing I've learned about mind control, the Super Soldier program, you remember that stuff was far out when I first started talking about it.
I know, and now it's all just like you said in MIT Magazine.
Yep, and here's the thing that people have got to understand. These demon-possessed, and by the way, when you watch what Matt Drudge does, kudos to Matt, because the amount of demon possession in the United States is becoming so great and so acute.
By the way, you said 15 years ago, and that's when I'd really roll my eyes, and I'm being honest, is you'd be like, then there'll be massive demon possession, and now it's all over the news. People are like turning into demons.
Well, actually, the demons are coming out of them. And this is what's happening. As the I'm going to give you something cool, okay? Not too heavy. As the electromagnetic spectrum is manipulated through HARP and 200 other patents, the ability for these entities that are demon-possessing most of the people that are in politics, I'm not making it that statement broadly, or forgive me, I am making it broadly, but it applies when they all sing and chirp the same hellish Harpy siren song, then you know that.
I want to hear about this because Hillary looks like she's possessed. Steve Quayle's our guest, and I hate every 10 seconds to go back and say, and you said this, and you said that, but I've interviewed this guy maybe 100 times. I mean, back 21 years ago, 20 years ago, he was like a go-to guy. And he'd be like, kid, I'm busy. You always let me come on your show. But, I got to tell you, I mean, I just thought the guy was entertaining. I mean, I believed that he believed what he was saying. And so much of what he said that I'd researched checked out. But then the other stuff was so wild. And then now I'm just thinking back during the break. It's freakish how accurate this guy's been. And then I would talk to, like, retired generals. And I mean recently retired. And they'd say, I like Steve Quayle. That's good info. And after you talk to a bunch of generals and intelligence operatives, they're telling you how great Steve Quayle is. You start really going, wow, what's really going on this planet? What does Steve Quayle really know? Because I know Steve Quayle really won't even talk on the air about stuff. He will talk privately with folks, and I've never had a chance to talk to him privately. I know Gary Haven has. It's just a totally insane world. And we have to understand, the people running things are evil. And whether you believe in God or not, they do. And they believe in the devil. And whether it's Bohemian Grove or Skull and Bones, they believe they're channeling spirits, like voodoo. And the spirits they believe they're channeling want to do evil things. I don't want to get into this today. We can have Steve back next week if he wants to do it in a separate show. But from the perspective of, just as an anthropologist or as a psychologist, you'll put that hat on, the elite believe in all this weird occult stuff. And every culture ends up getting into it. So is it genetic? Is it spiritual? And then you look at the practices that have happened throughout history, and you look at how the globalists are changing the atmosphere, changing the soil, changing the planet, doing things fundamentally to kill the planet, while they sit there claiming they love us and want to save the planet. So everything they say is basically the opposite. And along comes Donald Trump, who's for prosperity and who doesn't want to have wars and who isn't a globalist and who has been quietly reaching out for years to the Liberty Movement about what could he do to try to stop this. I mean, my life is a Twilight Zone episode. And then I want to get back to this, Steve, and then give me the floor. In fact, I'm going to skip this break so you have more time. I want to ask you a question. Getting back to this, I talked to Special Forces people. I talked to last night. I talked to Biggs, who's been in a lot of combat. And I said, what do you make of this Omar Mateen's father getting in, being in the vetted area? You got to go through hell to be part of that. The Democrats put up who they want. They put her right over her right or left shoulder. That's obviously a message. And Biggs is like, yeah, the message is we're taking the government over. The Democrats are with us. Nothing can stop us. He's got his jihad show, his Wahhabist program, his Pashtun program on broadcast TV in California and on the internet. He lives in New York. He goes down to Florida in Orlando to symbolically sit there with 50-plus dead, dozens wounded, or over 100 wounded, and stand there behind her and have that message sent out worldwide. Because I know the globalists, it's not just about here, it's about worldwide. We're in a trance, but the rest of the world gets these different messages. And then Biggs on air said, no, that's a message. Come in. This is it. We're taking over. This is the, you know, this is it. All's good. The government's with us. This is a plan. She's our Demi. Exactly what our other sources have said with Merkel. And then I made some phone calls to folks I know, and I said, what is that? And they go, it's a message, come on in, it's a takeover. So it's like a movie. They have these TV shows where they think somebody might be a secret jihadi inside Homeland Security and he's doing coded messages on TV. But we're not watching a TV show. This is happening. Now, I asked you what you thought it was. You said the same thing independently. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about the next few years, the next few months, where you see the state of the world, where you see everything going. I mean, your greatest hits of latest info, Steve Quayle, stevequayle.com.
Well, I think, Alex, where we're at now is the most perilous time in our history, our nation's history. And again, I agree with Joe Biggs what he said, because, again, that's my position also. But if you look under this, you know, one of the hardest things for people to grasp is the world of supernatural evil, okay? If you look at Hollywood prepping us from the first Alien shows, you know, the black and white ones, War of the Worlds, everything that's been done through Hollywood, now to some of the most sinisterly manifestations, Childhood's End. I encourage everybody to, you know, look at that. It was, I think, on the Sci-Fi Channel, Arthur C. Clarke. What we're being prepped for is basically the whole annunciation and the, whether people like it or not, the presentation of Lucifer to the world.
And giving up our free will and being uploaded to a silicon ship, which, for those that don't know who H.G. Wells was, or for folks that don't know who Arthur C. Clarke was, this is the inventor of the telecommunications satellite, like number three in command of the OSS and MI6, a total Luciferian, and he admitted Childhood End is basically the program.
Absolutely, and that's what, and I just want to bring this up real quick. That's why, and our True Legends, the DVD, The Unholy Sea, that's what everything is being prepped for. Look, Tom Horn, in his book, you know, Exo-Vaticana and stuff, what people don't understand is the most expensive research in the world that's on Mount Graham with the infrared telescope and the Lucifer device. Oh, gee, why'd they name it that? What we're doing, Alex, in this newest DVD is showing people step by step what is in play in the headlines, how it all plays into the globalist Luciferians. Let me make this clear. They're more determined in looking after and looking out for the second coming of Satan on the earth, because we know he takes over the earth for 3.5 years. People argue with me. I'm not going to argue with them. The bottom line is that now we have...
How could you argue now? It's a giant, every major globalist group's called Lucifer. I mean, they are just openly admitting it all.
Well, they're openly admitting it all. And see, that's the hard part. And somebody said, well, you just asked me too. And I think that's what some of the generals... By the way, You know, we've got Admiral Thomas Moore, one of the first guys I ever heard from.
I've interviewed him before he died. He exposed everything.
Yep, he exposed everything, but he told one of his research assistants, Sue Bradley, who's now gone to be with the Lord. The bottom line is, he said, you need to listen to Steve because he's telling people what is going to play out.
And he was the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff.
Yep, he was the head of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. Now, why would he say that? First of all, look, I'm not, you know, I talk to a lot of people like you do, but this was my calling to be a watchman. Trust me, it doesn't, and I say that's a biblical calling. God always declares the end from the beginning. So that's what my whole perspective is, always framed on Scripture. Now, obviously, people who hate Jesus, who hate God, who hate Christians. Oh, and by the way, isn't it amazing that, you know, when I was given the red list, the blue list, and the green list, you and I talked about that almost, I think, when you first started on radio. The guy that gave me that information is absolutely, you know, he was murdered for that information.
Steve, I've had so many guests that were murdered after they came on. And then I even talked to their condo manager, and she goes, yeah, you know, she said, get this to you. They're following her. She'll never kill herself. And then they kill her. And then I even have the police detectives call and go, yeah, no, they murdered her, Mr. Jones. You mind coming to Florida? I'm like, no. You know, it's just like, I just don't think the average person realizes how crazy this is, Steve.
Well, it's Murder, Inc., okay? And the deal is, now remember,
let me ask you this, then. Why are you and I still alive? Providence?
No, the intervention of the living God, Alex, and there are people praying for you. I remember one time you let me pray over you, and I prayed for your safety and the family. And I'm not saying, whoopee, it's not my prayers, but there are intercessors out there. You know, look, they may not like the way you act, I act, what we speak. You know, if you're too gruff or I'm too bottom line. But the thing is that we're still here by the grace of God. And I want to thank everybody who's listening to Alex Jones today. For praying for Alex's safety.
Oh, I can feel the prayers.
Safety.
Can't you feel the prayers, Steve?
Oh, absolutely. Let me say this, Alex. So many times I would be dead. So many times I've been betrayed by those closest to me. And I want to say this to you on the air. And please, don't go into whatever your security is. But whatever it is, double it, okay? When the FBI would, this is critical. When the FBI would not release the 8,000, 15,000 names, the majority of them are Christians, talk show hosts, ministers, when they wouldn't do that, and that's just absolutely...
Well, it was leaked. I mean, they're, Hillary's and Obama's enemy list is mainly media.
Yeah, but even beyond that, the bottom line is every church that preaches the gospel of Jesus Christ should have armed deacons. I'm not kidding you. You know,
The globalists know which ones they are and just send the minions.
Yeah, and here's the thing. We're in the time, let me share this. Prophet Isaiah said this, woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and light for darkness, that put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. It's like Isaiah's reading the headlines of all the mainstream press, and you've put up, you've done so many DVD or videos.
Enough about, getting to this, what do you make then of just this open, naked evil, and why would they be trying to install Hillary, who's obviously so ill? I mean, and what's going on?
Well, I think, you know, I don't know that she's going to make it to the nomination. And this is why I pray, and I encourage everyone to pray for Donald Trump's safety, okay? Look, everybody, here's what's interesting. Jesus said the love of money is the root of all evil. The control of money is the control of all evil. And when you got the world's leftist billionaires, what is it? Google itself has been in the White House 256 times or something.
And they're all, quote, obsessed with the Fountain of Youth. That's the East Bay Times today. And they want to take blood transfusions from children.
Right. Well, they're vampires, okay? And I understand what that means. You see, the Bible says the life is in the blood, okay? And obviously a child's blood has antibodies, you know, as long as he hasn't been vaccinated, and all the different things. And I want to make this clear. Ladies and gentlemen, when Alex is giving all these health food supplements and supplies, understand, it's not just a question of food that goes into your stomach, but it's cellular nutrition. It's building up your natural biodefenses. And it's interesting, Jesus said, out of your innermost being will spring forth rivers of living water. And our gut is really critical. That's the ganglionic.
And again, the Rockefellers that patented Zika in 54, I mean, you can look that up, folks, and all of them are obsessed with gut flora, all the synthetic pesticides, the dead earth, we have dead guts. They don't tell you, of course, and I'm not doing a plug, but I am doing a plug. When we sell true clean iodine, when we sell DNA Force, when we sell these things are the things that God gave us, Mother Nature in the earth, that I wouldn't be alive without, you know, I mean, literally colloidal silver. I mean, I have seen it. And so, yes, of course, we sell the things we believe in. We know we're good. It's symbiotic. I would never sell someone something that I didn't 100% know was good. People say, oh, you're such a good guy. What the hell? I'm not about to screw anybody over. And I don't understand, like, how I wouldn't screw somebody over. And I feel bad when I do bad things. And I see these other people. It's like they don't have a soul, Steve. They don't care.
Alex. That's the point. And you made it earlier. Here's the thing. The United States, in my opinion, is Mystery Babylon, and we become a habitation of devils, okay? And the hold of every foul spirit. What you're watching is soulless entities, okay? And what's interesting, you know, when you and I first did, you remember this, when we first did a show together back, you know, 20 years ago, let's say, the bottom line is whenever
21 years ago.
Yeah. You remember when we talked about the soul catcher chip? That absolutely would replace the human brain.
How did you know that? Now they admit they have a chip that's, quote, going to capture the soul. That's their big, big dream, Bezos and Thiel and the Rockefellers. Yeah.
Right, and why is the Defense Department spending so much money on identifying the neural pathways?
Well, let's go back then. You've been saying this. You've been on air since 1990. I've learned from folks you were writing articles and warning people in like the 80s and the late 70s. Where did you learn all this? Are you saying you were given it as revelation?
Yeah, I was. And here's a hard thing for people to believe. Look, I'm just a guy. I'm just an ordinary guy, but I serve an extraordinary God. I can't embellish anything, but I have to tell the truth. When I saw Jesus face to face, that's how I got saved. Okay, and by the way, I came out of film school to do really raunchy films, okay, and God changed all that, but God gave me a panorama of history. But he said this, he said, I'm only going to reveal it as it shortly comes to pass. You know, one of the books I've written that's just gone wild is Xenogenesis. That's genetic Armageddon.
You wrote that so long ago, and it's all happening.
Yeah, and here's what people have got to understand. God loves the human race. He sent Jesus to redeem us. And Alex, you know this. As you get deeper into this world, it becomes more and more evident it's spiritual. And when you try and talk to natural-minded people about the spiritual things, they don't get it. But yet when you see altars being set up before Satan, when you see Hollywood totally given over to Eyes, what was Kubrick's movie?
I've interviewed his daughter. Mark Dice, and this has happened to me, but this guy was on record so he could say it, was called into the head of a major TV production studio, and they said, Mark, we want to give you a national show, but Satan loves you, Lucifer loves you, let's pray to the devil, and I'm going to give you this job. And Mark wouldn't do it, so he didn't get the job. And, you know, I'll let him tell that story because, you know, it really happened to him. And, you know, he's had shows. It was, the point is if you don't know till you experience this. I mean, people just don't know who haven't been there.
And see, the thing is that, again, kudos to Matt Drudge for putting up all of the increasing...
And by the way, Matt Drudge knows they're coming after him. A Supreme Court justice warned him right before they killed the other one.
Yep, I understand. And then let's deal with that, okay? Scalia gets murdered. There's hardly anything said. There's no correct disposal, autopsy, or anything.
And a month later, they declare victory in the globalist publication, The Washington Post, and say he was in a secret society that ran the whole deal. They told us. We killed him in a ritual. Ha!
Yep. And ritual killings are increasing. Look, how many shows have you done? How many years have you spoken about the Bohemian Grove being there and stuff? How many times did we see the complete, if you will, the occult involvement in George Bush Sr.'s life and George Bush Jr.'s life? All these guys, let me say this, at the basis of even what we're seeing playing out before the world, and I believe Vladimir Putin is incredibly brilliant, and he sees the New World Order.
I'm not kissing Russia's ass, and I'm not a Russophile, but I've studied history. Russia was put in by the globalists under 85 years of enslavement to crush them. They got out of it. They're not perfect, but they're paying people to have kids. Their TV shows are don't drink fluoride. They're anti-New World Order. They're anti-major vaccination. They want clean vaccines. They want organic food. And Putin goes and, you know, talks to this Orthodox, you know, gentleman that's supposedly like his guru. And the thing is, I look at Putin, I hear what he says, and my gut tells me Putin is a Christian is for real.
Well, I got to share this with you. When a man tells the truth against all the lies coming against him, and let me share what's happened in Turkey, okay? Have you noticed, Alex, that obviously there's very little talk in the mainstream press about basically our nuclear weapons. And by the way,
are all surrounded. There's over 100
all
weapons.
Surrounded. And let me share this.
My great uncle put them in.
Don't get the idea that, you know, we have seen no escalation of, let's say, protection of that. And it's not just the warheads, the, you know, what, B-61 warheads.
Cruise missiles.
We have hydrogen weapons there. So, in effect, what Erdogan has done is he's assimilated or has, if he wants them, outside of going to war with them, he basically...
That's right. Well, Erdogan has had no relations with the Russians in 3 years. Suddenly he's meeting with their foreign minister, Lavrov, and others. What does that signal?
Well, that signals this, that obviously the plan was, and if you see, you know, Obama and Erdogan were supposedly best friends. Well, I just want people to think out of the box, okay? What would they say if instantly, overnight, and this isn't thinking too far out of the box, is that Erdogan were to announce that for national security and international peace, he's taken over the United States nuclear arsenal and NATO's arsenal within Incirlik base, okay? Well, people would absolutely start to, probably most of them would just go back to their iPods, iPads, or iPhones and just text a friend saying, you know, meet me at the bar or whatever tonight. The point that I'm trying to make is this. That is such a major deal. Look, NATO is toast, and I'll tell you why. It's destroyed from within with the immigration policies.
It's trafficking narcotics. And what message is Trump sending saying NATO's not our friend? That is revolutionary.
Well, Donald Trump's telling the truth. You know? See, here's the thing. When people, this is really infuriates.
Yeah, why do we always think of it's people that are close to us that are our biggest danger. It's the globalists. It's NATO. They're the ones running us, bringing the drugs in.
Oh, absolutely. Can I say this? The whole world centers around that. How about the Clinton Foundation, Larry Nichols? Man, he's laid it out for 20 years.
We got it going on.
And he's alive because of people praying for him. Man, the guy's had so many different health issues, and the fact
he's
that
battling lung cancer
still alive,
right now.
And you don't get any closer to the source. And if you look at all of the manifestations, you know, the constant cough is more than just any type of cerebral issues going on.
What is that? If
the constant cough is absolutely, there are people out there that know this stuff, and they're claiming that one would, I'll make this delicate, okay? For the first time, I'll be delicate. Her known people that she hangs out with aren't men, okay? Just like Bill Clinton doesn't supposedly have relations with his wife anymore, but, you know, 2,000-plus women. Well, what does that say to people? You know, here's the thing, Alex. You're never going to get the truth from the mainstream. If you got some guy walking around with her, shooting her up with Thorazine for whatever reason, you know, you've got...
She's a total basket case. They're walking around with a tranquilizer dart behind this crazy woman who we want to give nuke codes to.
I think she let the cat out of the bag when she said she short-circuited, okay? And I think some of the expressions that are on YouTube and stuff... Look, over the
years... So is she a Tesla that's like a total, like maybe a brain-dead robot? I mean, she's like a flesh puppet. Just up. She's what she looks like.
Well, I think that you said it earlier. I think that demons, a demon is a disembodied spirit, okay? And that's a whole different thing. They have intelligence, they have expression, they have lust. One of the best definitions for lust, and I believe it was the goodness of God that gave it to me, is the appetite of demons expressed through humans. That's why they want the blood sacrifice. Look, everything's coming out of Hollywood with a one eye covered. Every major star who's in the rock world is sending a message.
Hold on, Steve Quayle, you're on fire. We can go for 10 hours. Stay there. Back in 3 minutes, stevequayle.com. I find no fault with this man. I mean, it's just we are living in crazy times. I'm Alex Jones. Please don't take InfoWars for granted or Drudge or anybody. They're trying to shut us down. Two different stories up on InfoWars.com that counter this latest hysterical narrative that Trump wants a civil war, wants gun owners to start killing people. As he said, well, of course they're going to take your guns. What do you got left? The Second Amendment. Biden threatens Obama with a gun in 2008. Yet media attacks Trump for talking about the Second Amendment. I've got two guns. If he tries to fool with my Beretta, he's got a problem, Biden said. Then we got another article. Hillary suggested Obama assassination, yet media blasts Trump. So those are stories up on InfoWars.com. I'm not going to belabor this. We already mentioned it. nothing is going to reverse everything that's going on, the toxicity, the garbage. But if you don't have vitamin C, you die. And BioPQQ is the stuff that comets are made out of, that life is based on. The Japanese have figured out how to make it. There's a lot of synthetic fake forms that don't upload properly. They're $50 a bottle just for the dose we have in DNA Force. It's got a bunch of other, obviously, other things in it as well. But it's the best formula we could come up with. And it's five times less expensive than similar formulas. Because that's just what you do in nutraceuticals is you have 5 to 7 times markup. We have 100% markups, and then we do discounts. Like 40% off on Anthroplex right now, 50% off on Colloidal Silver, Silver Bullet, and InfoWarsLife.com. But DNA Force is so important. Peter Thiel wants, you know, kids' blood transfusions in the news to live longer and always at least do this stuff. What about BioPQQ that goes in and takes the equivalent of vitamin C? 500 cartons of blueberries is what one dose has just of BioPQQ. I mean, it's the next level of vitamin C. It's a true nutraceutical. InfoWarsLife.com. Or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And what's beautiful is we sell great products like 20% off on water filtration. We're running today at InfoWarsStore.com. Free shipping on orders $50 or more. 10% off additionally when you sign up for auto ship on stuff like coffee or nutraceuticals. LifeSpring survival straws, you name it. You have supported us. You've gotten great products. Third-party review sites give us 5-star reviews, and we're building something independent and real. That's a testament to resistance. So it's an Americana success story. So thank you for your support. Steve Quayle, this is a long segment. I want to give you the floor to roll because I'm jumping in a lot here. This is great, powerful radio, waking folks up. What do you expect them, or what's in the cards? What could they pull? Does Brexit concern them? Does Trump concern them? Obviously, there's not just evil in the universe. What else do you expect them to do with attempts to cause race riots, civil war, cop killing? And then in the final segment coming up, we're going to talk about your new True Legends, the series, TrueLegendsTheSeries.com. Steve Quayle.
Well, I think we're going to see massive more attacks on police. We're going to see massive more incidents of black people being murdered, you know, indiscriminately. Now, look, I am pro-cop, but I'm also against the plan. And here's what I got to tell everybody out there in law enforcement and in the military. You guys are already penetrated. I have cop friends all over the country listening to this show right now. And I've warned them all, and they say, you know, that's funny. That guy asked too many questions. Or that woman, it's like a spy novel or something. By the way, Assange just released the new WikiLeak of 296 brand new emails from Huma, and they're saying she committed multiple felonies, okay? Notice this, that she's always shown with Hillary. I believe she's Hillary's Muslim handler, okay? So what you're going to see is the vilification of Christianity increasing. You're going to see the war on guns. I don't know if you know the new plan, but gunsmiths are going to have to pay $2,500 a year in new charges. Everything will be taken, every method to vilify and absolutely slaughter the people who are having weapons. I'm talking both literally and figuratively. And, Alex, when you did the MIAC report, you remember that? I mean, that was spelled out. If everybody wants to really get it, go back and listen. Alex, you should put that one back up on prominence because I can tell you this. That was one of the most powerful shows, in my opinion, you've ever done, okay?
So when you announced Christians, gun owners, veterans are the number one enemy. So they've released another WikiLeaks. CNN spends it. Drudge has it red-linked. Newly released Clinton emails shed light on relationship between State Department and Clinton Foundation. That's what our CIA sources told us 4 years ago after Benghazi. Tosh Plumlee and others, Colonel Schaefer, wasn't CIA, but he was Defense Intelligence, is that she had... The government was blocking arms sales, but she, if you gave her money, would allow it. And so now we have the emails. This is incredible. Go ahead.
Well, I, anybody that understands the exporting of arms or importing, that all has to go with State Department approval, okay? So the Clinton Foundation was basically, it would be, the mafia would be kindergarten compared to this, okay? The problem is I don't know if you saw 50-some intelligence agents said why Donald Trump will be a bad guy. all those 50 intelligence agencies, you know, they can't understand the Pentagon lost $6.5 trillion. But we know where that went. Every bit of that money could be traceable and trackable. So what we have is the complete sellover. We have the takeover and takedown of the United States. And I believe it's the prayer of God's people for Donald Trump's safety. Look, I get the same emails you get. Why are you guys supporting Trump? Don't you know this? Don't you know that? Because of who hates him, you've spent your broadcasting career detailing it. Even in the days of the Bilderbergers, the Trilateral Commission, that stuff is so old. That's like 25 years old. But now we see all of the plays in their playbook. By the way, admit it or not, the Luciferians want World War III so they can get the Christians, Muslims, and Jews taken out of the picture. And then the pure doctrine of Lucifer can come forth. Well, now you've got Hollywood basically, talking behind the scenes. And listen, Alex, the perversion of animals aren't even safe. Those of you who are friend of animals, you got to understand even the animals are crying out to God because of the abuse against them. I'm talking sexual abuse. We're seeing every form of debauchery that can be imagined. Little children, pedophiles, four-year-old child brides, six-year-old child brides. And how about the women being slaughtered in the name of, Islam? Where are the perpetual voices for feminism? Here's the thing. A country cannot withstand external and internal attacks without falling. And what's is strange...
Well, that's what's totally clear. This is a total attack just on any institution, any stability. It is a scorched earth takeover.
Absolutely. And Alex, anything less than that is naivety. I hear people that are, basically couch potatoes saying, you and Jones need to do this, or Alex, I'm sure you get the emails, you need to do this, blah, 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 blah. My answer to them is get off your lazy asses and you do something. Yes. You can at least write a letter. Somebody says, well, that won't do any good. Well, try it. Now, look, here's the thing. I want to make this clear. I've said it twice in your show. I want to make it. You have to, ladies and gentlemen, break the control of mind control, electromagnetic warfare being used against you through the network news. Alex, you're finding out, I'm sure.
They send the frequency over. They even admit it. Now they're sending it over light bulbs at the police stations to, quote, calm the police. That's in mainstream news. Then they make fun of me saying, oh, it isn't happening. But it's admitted. That's why they put in this new global mandated light bulb.
Absolutely. And do you know the reason they took out of lead paint or took the lead out of paint years ago? You and I did a show on that 20-plus years ago, 21 years ago.
Can't see through
it. Was because they wanted to be able to spy into people's homes, and lead is a natural blockage for pretty much major, not only cosmic rays, but gamma radiation, too. So gamma scanners were being jammed. See, it's all about control. How about this? Everything the Defense Department's talking about lately, and DARPA especially,
They're building a breakaway civilization.
Yep, is basically everybody dies but them. So when we talk over the years about...
So let's talk about the Elysium plan. Let's look forward, not at current things. If they had their way, Lucifer's plan. Lucifer is talking to his top council of 13. He's promising these world leaders eternal life, all this power, all the things they admit they're obsessed with. We know he's deceiving them, but what is he claiming? They carry this out. How do they carry it out? Where does it lead to?
Right. Well, basically, he's claiming that they shall not die, that they'll have perpetual downloads, they'll have new bodies. And even, I remember I said this 20 years ago, that you can have a sexual experience downloaded through whatever Hollywood star or starlet you want. Now, that's common sense. How about micro-robotics and sex bots? Okay, a virtual world. I made this statement, and I stand by it. A virtual world, and whether it's games or whatever people do in the virtual world, is absolutely designed to rob them from a normal communication base and basically keep them so occupied in the pleasure centers of their brain and using their time so they've lost their ability for rational thought. And so that's cognitive dissonance. Then here's the deal. They're promising you unlimited power, unlimited knowledge. Basically, it's the knowledge of good and evil. The same lie that was told in the Garden of Eden is...
I'm going to give you eternal life. I'm going to give you all the knowledge. But the truth is you give over your free will.
Absolutely. And see that word free will. They hate that. They want to take that over.
And but it's crazy. It all says that, and now here we are living the beginning of it, and the average church is totally controlled and won't even warn people.
Well, I'd say this. Anybody that goes to a church and won't deal with these issues, get out of it. Flee it. Come out from her. Let you be a partaker of her plagues. And look, here's the deal again. We're seeing absolute rape, pillage, and plunder. Here's a hard statement for people to grab. Rape, pillage, and plunder. The United States they have formerly known has gone under. We've been cherry-picked, and that's what you're seeing. You're seeing a mass agreement, let's call it, agreement to basically take the United States out of the scene and insert the global power. And you know the last thing standing against it is the American gun owner on the left hand, and on the right hand, praying Christians. Look, prayer does change things. I want to make a statement. I know the Old Testament very well. I know the New Testament very well. There has never been a time when in any history of any battle where God's people could fight it in their own strength. It was God who always gave the victory. So the answer to everybody is their personal faith in God. I'm telling you this. If it weren't for that, Alex, everything you and I are doing to try and get
because God's free will, you have to ask God to do it. Amen. You can't just sit there and hide. You have to put your own skin in the game, then ask God in, and then God will take you the rest of the way. Or you may be destroyed, but only as an example to inspire others for the larger victory. But you have to commit, remember be ready this. To die, and ask God for the guidance.
Right. Remember this, that the bottom line is, once the devil's through with these people, Hillary may be a good example, a poster child in real time, he casts them aside. And what's fascinating to me, I've watched people who have literally sold themselves to hell. I've watched him destroy. I used to say God, and I think I still say this, but with one caveat. God judges nations in history and usually, you know, people in eternity. Obviously, the eternal judgment.
But you're judged repeatedly on every level. So there's a little prejudgment like Herod or anybody.
Yeah, exactly. But those are the exceptions. And when you have, and the Democratic National Convention, you know, I got to tell you something. If anybody's a Democrat and a Christian, how can you stand for the platform that denies God literally by their own statements, 2012, I think it was, and basically has made war on the people of faith? You've got an entity in the White House who can.
They were so arrogant, they thought no one would notice no American flags.
Yep. And so the thing that we're at is this. Everything, and this is, we need to have an active participation in saying, our way of life, our borders, our nation, our culture. You know, remember, Alex, when there was no modifier before American? When you were an American, whether you came from Korea, Japan, you know, Africa, you know, then when they started, I remember doing this show, I said, when they started saying Afro-Americans, it was over. Because the national identity was we came for what America stood for. And America no longer stands
for. The identity was you believed in level playing field, free market, right to self-defense, private property, and the right of religious freedom.
Absolutely. Now, what are we being told? By all, let me share this. If the Christians would understand that they are in the targets of these devils, and I'm going to go on record again. I don't think people got it. If the FBI does not release the names of the 15,000, and it's not just talk show hosts, and it's not just people who are political enemies, but these are pastors that are speaking the truth, then they will be complicit. And it appears that they have been ordered not to release those. Because here's the deal. Jesus said Christians are the salt of the earth. Jesus said Christians are the light of the world. And when you lose the salt and you lose the light, then you get trampled or you basically get murdered under the feet of the stampede.
Absolutely. And just to clarify, the new Drudge stuff is from Judicial Watch getting emails. I don't know what Julian Assange, who I think is an honorable guy overall, watching him for years, what is he doing not releasing these the full data dump he says will bring down Hillary? Shouldn't he release it now?
I think he absolutely must, because here's the deal. A little bit at a time won't get the job done, because you'll just see apologists. Now, I want to go back to this. What does it say when you've got a CNN commentator literally asking or basically saying, kill the son of a bitch, his words, you know, without due process? You've got the same thing going on Snowden. And by the way, there are rumors he's dead, and then Greenwald said he's not dead. His girlfriend says he's dead. I don't know. But his 64 character encryption or whatever that was, when he said now is the time, my guess is there will be simultaneous releases of both WikiLeaks and what Edward Snowden has. And, you know, isn't it amazing? The only people calling him a traitor are the globalists. The only people that want him dead, too, are the globalists.
That's right. He's exposing their criminal activities. They're calling for his death. They kill these DNC staffers and say, oh, so people got shot in the back. Big deal.
Well, again, ladies and gentlemen, it's Murder, Inc.
Let me ask you this. What's going to happen to the average trendy that doesn't know how to tie their shoelaces when stuff collapses?
They're going to get basically either taken out in the first wave, or if they're prominent enough with enough people under them, they'll go into the camps, be re-educated, and they'll become, you know, the brown shirts on steroids. And let's take that for instance. You've seen U.S. military now at probably 50% or less capacity, whether it's the Air Force and aircraft that won't fly, the Marines, the Navy. There are stories out there in the Defense Department that Russia on three different occasions have demonstrated don't go to war with us by using electronic countermeasures that cause a submarine to surface, that shut down the Donald C. Cook twice, you know, and has taken out airplanes. So the thing is that I think, again, those who call for war are evil. I believe, again, as you said, the thing that strikes me amazing about Vladimir Putin, okay, is that he cares about his own people. He cares about national identity. Look, when he has a Russian
He's the anti-globalist. Say what you want, but that's a fact. So is Trump. Stay with him. All right. Getting into these news articles. Again, it's not tuning InfoWars horn. It is about realizing the position anyone is in when they resist tyranny. And we have DrudgeReport.com, picking up the InfoWars.com, Paul Watson article yesterday, Twilight Zone, Orlando Terrorist Dad cheers Clinton under it, will Hillary disavow? And that link to a story today, thousands of articles, Hillary disavows, Politico, Breitbart, you name it. But she didn't do it. Her campaign did. No. We need her asked 500 times. Just like they did with the KKK and, David Duke. That's not good enough. We want to see her talk about it and how she feels bad that he supported her. Because that's illogical, but that's how they operate. That's what we want to see. Five more minutes to the next hour with our guests, Steve Quayle. Then Paul Watson from London takes over, our great writer that, you know, sees what's happening, the hypocrisy, and writes about it. You put InfoWars with Paul and Drudge, and it's a trifecta. But they are trying to come after the free press. They are trying to basically take things over. And I know that the devil wages war, the Antichrist wages war against the saints and overcomes them for a period, but we're only planting seeds for after all of that, whether this is the real Antichrist, this system, or there's many Antichrists that come before it. It's all signatures, waves of the same paradigm. That we are affecting the battlefield future spectrum for souls, for minds, to see what we're facing. It isn't about temporarily winning the day. It's about winning the entire war, not the battle. Steve, is that accurate?
Well, okay, Alex, the thing is that in the last 5 minutes, I want people to take a reality check on the world. Ask yourself, why in the world is every nation that's not only a part of NATO, but pretty much all of them, with the exception of China and Russia, undergoing mass upheaval? And you can't get away from the fact that it goes back to out of the ashes will the new phoenix arrive. You've got to get rid of the old world order, and I'll make that simple. You've got to get rid of biblical Christianity. You have to get rid of, the prophets of the Old Testament.
You have to crush this culture, and I forgot, you got cut off getting into Putin. Go ahead.
Well, no, I'm sorry. I didn't pay attention up to the break, but, I actually forgot where I got cut off from. But here's the thing. People have got to understand this is not a trial run. This is the total takedown. They better stand up. And, 19% of Republicans now don't want Donald Trump. You have to do what they do. You have to identify your enemies. Every single one of those people that went along, the head Republicans that are against Donald Trump, those are the people that are in bed with the
the Luciferians. They can talk that they've had a spiritual experience. Yeah, Satan probably showed up and patted them on the back. And I think that it's important that if Hollywood is preparing you for the return of Satan, and people go to all these movies, and people who go to churches demand where your pastor stands, because now it's your family's life is at stake. And I want to just make another appeal. Ladies and gentlemen, as important as all the survival items are, the stuff that will provide the nutrients to your body, the natural defenses, and Alex, you got a good price on the products you're selling, along with the big Berkey water filter. No one should be drinking water unless they have their wells.
You cannot trust anything the globalists do, and we do the independent test of the water. It's got higher levels of Prozac than could be in runoff. They're adding chemicals to the water. Back in 75, more with Steve Quayle and Paul Watson from our Britannic Majesty's Command Base. All right, final segment with Steve Quayle. SteveQuayle.com. Alex Jones. Check out his new film as well there that is extremely powerful. I've seen it, TrueLegendsTheSeries.com. I want to get him back up next week. He's so busy, I'm busy. Months go by, he doesn't come on. I want to start getting him up every week if he can with this quickening, this key time in history that is taking place right now. Steve Quayle, in the 5 minutes we've got left, other points you want to make about the state of the world?
Well, I think one of the critical things is if you notice Zika, the viruses, you know, Alex, you and I were on together when we talked about the...
And you said 15, 20 years ago they'd use these viruses through mosquitoes to sterilize us.
Right, and here's the deal. Notice the babies are the ones that are targeted. The hardest point for me to get across, and the deepest burden of my heart is, ladies and gentlemen, 9 out of 10 people you encounter are targeted for destruction one way or the other. The Deagle Report, even they just sent out a thing. Look, we don't have anything supernatural. We just know the trends that are happening. When we went on the show with that, Alex, it caused an uproar around the world. But nothing's changed. So we're coming to the point where we've become a hissing sound. In other words, the respect America used to command is now a hissing. People hold us in contempt. Everything we used to stand for that was right is now wrong. And everybody in the world sees how plain this whole theater of the absurd is, and self-destruction. See, remember, ladies and gentlemen, Germany is self-destructing. France is self-destructing. Scandinavia is self-destructing. All these kings, queens, whatever, parliamentary leaders, presidents, they're all part of the same thing. Jesus said the whole world lies in the evil one. He didn't say
they are self-destructing to make way for the one world government.
Absolutely. And Alex, again, if people want to know where this is going, I recommend two things. I'm done writing about the future when it comes to Xenogenesis, Xenogenesis. Then go on my website and order it. And the Unholy Sea, go to my website, SteveQuayle.com.
Let's spend a few minutes on that because we're not Catholic bastards, but this Pope calling for world government, saying let the Muslims in, Christians are bad. I mean, he actually says this stuff. This guy is a demon.
Well, yeah, and he also kissed the Quran, okay? Well, when he kissed the Quran, he can I say this? Every chance he gets, he puts down Jesus Christ. And there are traditional Catholics that are absolutely furious with this, but yet we saw it when Malachi Martin was murdered years ago. And by the way, he was no dummy. I think he spoke 17 languages, and he was a Jesuit. But people have got to understand, they've got to recognize that all of the revelations coming about Planet X and this life, exoplanet might have life and all that. We deal with the greatest cover-up in history, which is the cover-over of history. And you can't get away from it. All roads right now lead to Rome. And, you know, you've had Steve Pachinik on, and he can tell you stories about Aldo Moro. You probably heard his story about that. But what you're seeing right now, ladies and gentlemen, is, again, the takedown and breakdown of traditional Christianity and the insertion of radical Islam. And if you read the Quran and the Hadith, there's no differentiation. Now, there are good Muslims, I'm sure, but the problem is when they come into control, if you don't toe the line of Sharia, you get whacked. And again, where is the women's movement of all the Muslim women who are being slaughtered, hung, butchered, stoned, drowned?
Clearly, Orthodox Islam is going to be used as an operating system to oppress the West.
Very well stated. I couldn't say it better. And so here's the thing, Alex. at the end of the day, again, I want to just thank everybody who praised for Alex and his family.
And you too. I want to thank folks for the prayers. Thank you. Thank you, yes.
Yeah, yeah. And I mean, it's important, ladies and gentlemen, you asked the question, Alex. I believe I gave the only answer I have. It's because of believers who want the truth. Remember this. They, the Illuminati, the globalists, they only live in a world of lies. There is no truth in them. So if you're listening to the mainstream press, you might as well just put your ear up to Satan's mouth, because that's who's whispering in your ear, but they no longer whisper. They shout it through their megaphones of broadcast TV.
Because they're scared and they know their time is short, so the devil sends the beast with wrath. Thank you, Steve.
Absolutely.
Quill. Paul Watson from London, straight ahead.
We are back live on the Alex Jones Show this fourth hour with me, your host, Paul Joseph Watson. Coming up later in the show, we get more into Hillary's health. Obviously, they're trying to keep the lid on this. We've had CNN, we've had the Washington Post, we've had basically all of the mainstream media desperately trying to dismiss this as a conspiracy theory. Of course, yesterday we had the big Daily Beast hit piece, which is nothing more than a Clinton mouthpiece, absolutely proven. Again, trying to make the case that this is all contrived. This is just a manifestation of overactive imaginations of right-wing radicals, right-wing extremists, completely omitting all the medical experts, all the health experts who say that Hillary Clinton has major problems. So we're going to get more into the cover-up. But first, obviously, Alex has covered this earlier in the show. We had Julian Assange of WikiLeaks drop the bombshell of bombshells last night during his appearance on a Dutch TV show, where he said, or he at least implied, that the source for the DNC email leaks was murdered DNC staffer Seth Rich. Now, he didn't blatantly say it outright, but we've probably played the clip already. If not, we'll get to it later. He very strongly suggested, when pushed, when grilled, that indeed Seth Rich, not Russia, not Vladimir Putin, not Russian hackers, but Seth Rich, the murdered DNC staffer, shot dead in the back by supposed robbers who didn't actually take any of his possessions in Washington, D.C., he suggested that he may have been the source. Obviously, that is very disturbing information, given what we know about the Clinton body count. But of course, that's just another conspiracy theory, so we don't have to worry about it. But this gets even more interesting, and I'm going to do a video on this later tonight. I'll be up again until 3 a.m., no doubt. But it gets even more interesting, and I don't think anybody's really picked up on this so far today. Because in the aftermath of Assange dropping this bombshell, again suggesting, implying that maybe the Clintons had something to do with the death of this, the murder of this DNC staffer, given that he was the source for the leaks. Again, he didn't say that outright, but that was the implication. It's very interesting today if you look at WikiLeaks' Twitter page, because they've posted two tweets that directly relate to assassination. Now, the first is a video of former senior Hillary Clinton strategist Bob Beckel expressing his support that Julian Assange be assassinated. Let's go to that clip.
I say it's the way to deal with this is pretty simple. We got special ops forces. I mean, a dead man can't leak stuff. This guy's a traitor, a treasonous, and he has broken every law of the United States. The guy ought to be, and I'm not for the death penalty, so if I'm not for the death penalty, I only want to do it, illegally shoot the son of a...
And again, that is former senior Hillary Clinton strategist Bob Beckel on Fox News expressing his support that Julian Assange be assassinated. Now, bear in mind, this is not a new clip. This is several years old. So you ask the question, why is WikiLeaks posting this several years old video clip about someone wanting to assassinate Julian Assange on the WikiLeaks Twitter page as of 5 hours ago? Why had they posted that? And then you look again at the next tweet. They posted the Twitter page, the tweet again. This is from August 2013, a tweet by Michael Grunwald, who is now writing for Politico. He wrote a book called New Deal, The Hidden Story of Change in the Obama Era. So this was basically a pro-Obama hack who went on to join Politico. And this is his tweet, which WikiLeaks again has screenshotted and posted. This is his tweet from 3 years ago. Quote, I can't wait to write a defense of the drone strike that takes out Julian Assange. So why is WikiLeaks posting a video and a tweet about the assassination of Julian Assange, given that both are at least 3 years old, the day after Assange implies that the source for the DNC email leaks was murdered DNC staffer Steph Rich, I think that was his name. Why are they posting it? This is not just a coincidence. I'm going to go on to make a video about this because, of course, a few days ago we had James Woods come out, the actor and now pretty much a conservative commentator, asking for odds on if Julian Assange would survive long enough to see out the November elections. That was a big story a few days ago. It came out before this Seth Rich revelation. Him asking, given that Assange has promised to release more emails, again, exposing Hillary Clinton's ties to founding, to transferring weapons to ISIS, her connection with Lafarge, the French company, that again has given money directly to ISIS, more emails regarding to the corruption of the Clinton Foundation, more emails regarding vote rigging, election fraud, all that is promised. That's all in the pipeline from WikiLeaks. So you had James Woods speculating, is Assange even going to survive for all this to come out? And people say, well, you know, if they take out Julian Assange, then everything would still get released. You know, he's merely the head of the organization. WikiLeaks is a large organization. They're going to have other people who will get the information out. While that's true, Assange is such a figurehead. I mean, look at who does all the interviews. Look at who gets all the media attention. It's Julian Assange. He basically is WikiLeaks. So, yes, the information might still come out, but it would get nowhere near the traction that it does with Assange as the figurehead pioneering the release of all this damning information about Hillary Clinton. Again, much more information, many more revelations in the pipeline, according to Assange himself. So why are they tweeting about Julian Assange's assassination the day after they dropped the bombshell that Seth Rich, again, the DNC staffer, the murdered DNC staffer shot in the back in Washington, D.C. in a murder that the police say is unexplained, they're still investigating it, implying that he's the source. Again, murdered. And then the day after, posting tweets about the assassination of Julian Assange. Very interesting. Of course, he's holed up in the Ecuadorian embassy in London, not far from me, and has been for years and years at great taxpayer expense. So, you know, they would say, well, how could they possibly assassinate him? Well, I guess that Julian Assange has probably got people tasting his food before he eats it at this point. Given that they've put out these tweets, I mean, how else would you explain it? It can't really be a coincidence that they put out tweets again, warning about the assassination, telegraphing his fear of assassination, that's how I see it, the day after these Seth Rich revelations or implications are made by Assange. I don't think that's a mere coincidence. And again, we've got people speculating that, you know, Assange could be a victim. He couldn't even make it. He may not even make it to the November elections, given all this damning information that could come out in the coming weeks. Extremely interesting goings on. And concurrent to this, obviously, you've got the Hillary health scandal, the massive cover-up that's now taking place, and the article is up. Took me a good few hours to write it. This is up on Infowars.com. Clinton-controlled Daily Beast labels Hillary health questions a hoax. Yes, it's a complete imagination. We've invented it out of thin air. Well, of course, you can go back to 2008, and we've got this clip now. where the leftist media was obsessed, constantly covering questions regarding the health of John McCain, Republican presidential candidate, and whether he was fit to take office. Let's go to that clip.
During the 2008 campaign, the mainstream media wouldn't let up, remember that, over John McCain's age and his health. Take a listen.
Is McCain simply too old to get elected?
If it's John McCain's health we're talking about, and he's running for the highest office in the land, his health, with limits, becomes the public business.
How concerned are doctors that this skin cancer may, in fact, return?
So again, you've got the leftist media back in 2008, absolutely obsessed, blanket coverage, demanding to know the answer as to whether John McCain had health problems that would impede him, that would make him unfit to take office. Fast forward to 2016, now that we're asking those questions, oh, it's unnecessary, it's conspiratorial, it's not an issue. Even though Hillary Clinton has been, you know, falling over for the past 7 years, even though she had a blood clot on her brain in 2012, even though she's exhibiting all this bizarre behavior, even though Secret Service police who attend her events, who provide security at her events, say that she can barely make it off the stage after giving a speech, that she's constantly dizzy, disorientated, falling over, having to be helped back into her car. All of that's a conspiracy theory, you right-wing nut. How dare you even ask the question of Queen Hillary? Well, they asked it of John McCain back in 2008. They asked it over and over again. Wasn't a conspiracy theory then, was it? This is a headline from CNN, 2008. McCain to allow peek at medical records. 8 years ago, Senator John McCain will give select members of the media a three-hour glimpse of his medical records. John McCain, they demanded to see his medical records. They saw them. Wasn't a conspiracy theory back then, so why is it now? We'll be back with more on The Alex Jones Show Live after the break. Don't go away. So on Monday, CNN came out and basically tried to trash these questions over Hillary's health by saying it was just one big conspiracy theory. They said, quote, her personal physician, talking about Hillary Clinton, her personal physician said 1 year ago that she was physically fit to serve as president. Oh, well, that settles it then. Hillary Clinton's own personal physician said that she's fine, so let's just accept that as gospel. Let's not even question that. You flash back 8 years previously, you had CNN reporting that John McCain had to open up his health records to the media because they wouldn't shut up asking him about his ill health. Again, continuing from CNN 8 years ago. Senator John McCain will give select members of the media a three-hour glimpse at his medical records Friday. If elected, McCain, the 71-year-old presumed Republican nominee, would be the oldest president of the United States, beating Ronald Reagan by 3 years. Again, Hillary Clinton is almost 69. She's almost the age that John McCain was back in 2008. But now it's a conspiracy theory even to ask the question. CNN said, oh, look, Hillary's own personal physician said she's perfectly fine a year ago. So let's just accept that. That settles it then. Again, the shocking lack of self-awareness with the mainstream media is just incredibly funny on a day-to-day basis. They still don't get why only 6% of the public trust them. And yet this is what they come out with. Again, John McCain constantly grilled about his health 8 years ago to the point where he had to have this private session for the media where he provided 1,000 pages of his medical history for members of the media to look at for 3 hours. Fast forward 8 years, Hillary Clinton, more chronic health problems than John McCain, more signs that she's unfit to be president, more health experts, medical professionals coming out on the record and saying there's something going on here, but it's all a conspiracy theory. Again, no demand from the leftist media to see the health records of Hillary Clinton, and for that matter, Donald Trump as well. This should be a regular thing every single election. We need to know if the people we elect are physically fit to serve. So then, of course, yesterday you had the Daily Beast weighing in with Ben Collins and the rest of them, prostitutes for the Clinton operation. Again, two hit pieces on the same day, one against me and InfoWars, one against Mike Cernovich, who is an author and talks about many of the same things that we do. And he has been the other primary progenitor of questions surrounding Hillary Clinton's health. In fact, Cernovich, on Saturday, I believe it was on the weekend, he was the first one to draw attention to those photos that were taken back in February in South Carolina of Hillary Clinton being helped up the steps, you know, by Secret Service agents, obviously having difficulties walking. He was the one that highlighted those, splashed on the Drudge Report afterwards, made national headlines all weekend, and that's when the media came out full throttle to try and shut down these questions. So on the very same day, the Daily Beast, which, by the way, is owned by a company called IAC. Who do you think sits on the board of directors at IAC, the company that owns the Daily Beast? Oh, it's none other than Chelsea Clinton, the vice chair of the Clinton Foundation, the daughter of Hillary Clinton. Well, imagine my shock. No conflict of interest there whatsoever. So again, as this begins to build, they come out with two different hit pieces against me and Mike Cernovich, the two primary progenitors, at least in the current news cycle, of this Hillary health problem scandal. I put out the video 6 days ago now, asking what was wrong with Hillary Clinton. It's now over 2 million views. This went viral. This really shook them up. And on the same day, this Clinton mouthpiece, the Daily Beast, came out with hit pieces against both myself and Mike Cernovich. On the same day, called Cernovich a, quote, date rape apologist. Again, tried to completely drag his name through the mud. This media outlet that constantly defends Hillary Clinton, constantly trolls and bashes her political adversaries, owned by a company whose board of directors includes Chelsea Clinton. Just a coincidence, nothing to worry about. You know, even Cenk Uygur, who we're certainly not fans of, but he's certainly not, you know, a right-wing conservative ideologue. He's a left-winger. Even he has come out and basically said that the Daily Beast is just a mouthpiece for the Clinton operation. We'll get more into it after the break on The Alex Jones Show Live. Don't go away. The White Live is the fourth hour of The Alex Jones Show. We're going to get back into the news, Hillary's health scandal and the Daily Beast hit piece. But first, I wanted to remind you about the specials at InfoWarsStore.com. Again, unlike CNN, we're not funded by corrupt dictatorial governments like Bahrain. You know, we're not funded by George Soros like Media Matters is. We're not owned by the Clinton Foundation like the Daily Beast. So we have to make our own money through hard work and through selling actual products to you. This is why we need you to go to InfoWarsLife.com. We've got Get Off the Grid Mega Special Silver Bullet Colloidal for 50% off at InfoWarsLife.com. This is one of the biggest sales ever at InfoWarsLife.com. Our top-selling silver bullet colloidal silver is now a whole 50% off for a limited time. That's just $9.95 a bottle, the equivalent of a Black Friday level special in August. Silver bullet is super concentrated into three times the dose of normal colloidal silver, and it's one of the highest quality out there. Again, we need you to drive us on. This is how we get at the top of the Drudge Report. This is how we challenge the national narrative. This is how we take on the mainstream media, not through George Soros donations of $100 million, not through cozy deals with dictatorial governments like CNN does, not through being owned by the Clinton Foundation like the Daily Beast, who have gone bankrupt like five times, but they keep coming back like some reanimated corpse. Because again, no one's listening to them, no one trusts them, but they've got big money establishment backing. We haven't. Our only backers are you getting the products. We've also got InfoWars Solar Base Station Power Supply, which is now 33% off at InfoWarsStore.com. Again, get self-sufficient, get healthy, and in the process, support what we do here at InfoWars. It's never been more crucial in the run-up to this election. So get the products and support us at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, going back to what I was talking about with the Daily Beast, again, basically an arm of the Democratic Party establishment. In fact, when it came out in those leaked emails that the DNC had run this dirty tricks campaign against Bernie Sanders, had decided from the start that they wanted Hillary, that they were going to do everything in their power to phase out, to dismiss, to deride the campaign of Bernie Sanders, you saw the exact same narrative being pushed by the Daily Beast, because it's a Clinton mouthpiece. Again, it's owned by IAC, whose board of directors includes Chelsea Clinton, vice chair of the Clinton Foundation. This is a supremely biased media outlet. Nobody even hardly reads it anymore, but again, because it gets play, it gets support, it gets backing from the rest of the mainstream media circle jerk, they still have some influence. They had to remove their comment section last year, I believe, because they said, oh, the content is more important than your comments. Well, we know why they removed the comment section, because independent scientific studies show that comment sections in news articles often have more impact on how people perceive, understand, and receive the content of the article than the article itself. So they judge whether the article is trustworthy or not based on the comments, not the text of the article. That's why all these big mainstream media outlets a few years ago started deleting, removing their comment sections. And Daily Beast is one of them. Again, cutting off their own nose to spite their face, losing all that traffic from the comments simply because they don't want their crap to be challenged by anyone with a different opinion. That's why they're losing traffic. That's why they're losing influence. Yet they still come out with these ridiculous hit pieces, which I've completely eviscerated and debunked in this article. Again, this was their headline yesterday in the Daily Beast. Is Hillary dying hoax started by a pal of Alex Jones? Again, they approached me for this interview a couple of days ago. They didn't include, shock horror, the most important comments that I made to them. They just included what suited their narrative. So again, absolutely ridden with errors from beginning to end, starting with the third word of the article in the headline. Completely wrong. I never said Hillary was dying. I said she had health problems. If you want to look at it that way, we're all dying, but I never implied that her death was imminent, which is what that headline implies. Complete nonsense. Again, he couldn't make it, this Ben Collins hack, couldn't make it past the third word of his article before completely misleading his readers. Line number two. They claim, again, in the headline, in the fifth word, so they made it to the third word before lying. The fourth word they managed to get past, but by the fifth word, he was lying already. They said that the Hillary health scandal, this whole controversy, was, quote, started by me. Of course, it wasn't started by me. In fact, you can go back 7 months and see that Breitbart wrote an article and published it with all these different health experts talking about what, quote, what's seriously wrong with Hillary Clinton's health. Did I reignite the controversy with this viral video? Yes. As did Mike Cernovich with his information, as did others. You know, then Fox News picked up on it and others. Did I start it? No, completely inaccurate. Extremely sloppy research to claim that I started this when people have been talking about it for 4 years since she had her blood clot. So again, completely inaccurate. Line number three, the subheadline of this Daily Beast article asserted that I cited Martin Shkreli as my only medical source. Completely wrong. The original viral video, which is what this article is supposedly about, doesn't contain any citation of Martin Shkreli. None whatsoever. In fact, the people I cite are in the Breitbart article from 7 months before. Neurologist Dr. Daniel Kasache. Dr. Nicholas C. Bambakidis. These are health medical experts that say Hillary Clinton has major health problems. Those are the people who I cited in the video. I flashed up the Breitbart article in which those health experts are quoted. So again, to say that I only cited this one individual as my only medical source, complete nonsense. This is how the mainstream media rolls. Again, they didn't mention the fact, as I communicated in the actual interview, which they didn't publish, that also John Cardillo, a former NYPD officer who provided VIP security detail, he spoke personally to a federal agent and another NYPD officer who told him directly that Hillary basically cannot stand up after giving a speech. She's got dizziness, disorientation. She's got major problems. Again, I told them that in the interview. I talked about it in the viral video. Did they put it in the article? No. This is the mainstream media. Complete tissue of lies from beginning to end. Also, lie number four. And this is funny. This is hilarious. He basically said in the email, oh, what do you think about this comedian, Patton Oswalt, citing his anonymous, quote, therapist friend who told him that Donald Trump has borderline personality disorder. And he was trying to make that into the central issue, like that had credibility. So he just wrote an entire article bemoaning the fact that I don't name my anonymous sources, which that's the whole point. They remain anonymous. They don't want to end up like Seth Rich. Again, the health experts I talked to in private, as well as the ones who already went public. So he wrote an entire article bemoaning the fact that I don't name these anonymous sources. Then he cites an anonymous source provided by a comedian to try and back up his assertion, his implication, that it's Trump and not Hillary Clinton who has psychological problems. So he did the very thing that he accused me of doing and tried to use it as an argument. And again, he also said that I claimed Hillary Clinton has Parkinson's disease, syphilis, brain damage, a brain tumor, autism, degenerative disease, drug problems. He said that I said she had all of those. Well, no, I never said she had all of those. I said those were some of the issues that medical experts were speculating she might have. And again, I said to him in the email, I don't know what she has. I'm not a doctor. But these professionals are saying that there's something going on here. Go back to 2008. Again, the media hounded John McCain to release his health records, which he did for the media to look at. 1,000 pages, he gave them 3 hours. He said, this is my medical history. Take a look. They didn't find anything that would have seriously impaired him becoming president. But now in 2016 with Hillary Clinton, who is almost the same age as John McCain was back then, it's a conspiracy theory. It's a fantasy of wingnuts to even ask questions about it. Again, this is why only 6% of people in America trust the mainstream media. Again, they've got a history of lying about InfoWars. Olivia Nutsy, or however you pronounce her name, I don't really care. Although she gets very upset about it, which is why I'm going to pronounce it wrongly over and over again. She claimed that Alex Jones denied the moon landings took place, something that never actually happened, which I pointed out in the article at the time that Alex is actually friends with Buzz Aldrin, has had him on the show, and he doesn't believe that. If you want to believe that, fine. But she wrote an article saying that Alex Jones said the moon landings never happened. He never said that. It was an outright lie. She got called out on it, and then suddenly she went quiet. In fact, she went quiet after I asked her how likely it was for her editors to put her on the case of routing out corruption and scandals related not to Rand Paul, which was her obsession at the time, but around Hillary Clinton. Now, as soon as I asked her that question, she said, oh, I'll ask my editor. And then mysteriously that tweet was deleted and she went completely quiet about it. Very interesting, given that this publication, The Daily Beast, is basically controlled by the Clintons, is a Clinton mouthpiece. So that article is up on Infowars.com again. They're very concerned about this. You had CNN on Monday trying to poo-poo it, saying it was a conspiracy theory. The same news organization that back in 2008 featured a report about John McCain opening up his medical history. Again, we played the clip earlier. The leftist media hounded John McCain to open up his medical history, and he did. Hillary Clinton, you can't even ask the question. Very sensitive about this, aren't they? Very sensitive indeed. So again, we'll continue to track it. Of course, we had a story earlier today. Again, there was another neurologist on Fox News who came out and said that there needs to be transparency on this. Hillary Clinton needs to come clean about what's wrong with her. At least give us the records. If there's nothing to see, then fine, we'll move on. Just as we did back in 2008 with John McCain. But no, we can't even ask the question. It's a wild conspiracy theory. So we're going to keep digging into that, but let's move on to some more news now. This is out of the Express. The cultural enrichment of Europe continues. It's not safe in Germany anymore. German family flee to Russia to claim asylum. A German family has fled their homeland and is seeking asylum in Russia after claiming they are no longer safe in their own country. And they basically go on to state that the German government, the media is totally corrupt. The migrants they're bringing in are destroying the country. Now they're fleeing to Russia to try and get a family life, to try and rebuild their own lives. Absolutely amazing, given that tourism has slumped completely in Germany, as Breitbart reports. As the number of migrants requesting asylum in Germany rises, the country's tourism industry is suffering. And they're talking about, in some cases, if you look at tourists from Japan, South Korea, and Taiwan, 40% down on last year. 40%, that's a huge slice of the tourist industry that Germany has lost out on. And when they ask these people why they're not visiting anymore, well, people cite crime and terrorism, specifically as a result of the migrant crisis. So now, not only socially, but Germany is starting to lose out financially from importing over 1 million Muslim migrants over the past year. We've also got reports of these secret night flights coming in from Turkey, where they're covering up, again, thousands of migrants being flown in directly from Turkey, from other countries in the Middle East. Again, that's not confirmed, but a lot of whispers about that on the internet over the past couple of days. This is out of RT. This was an interesting article. Given what we were talking about with Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, kill Russians and Iranians, threaten Assad, says ex-CIA chief backing Clinton. Former CIA Deputy Director Michael Morell, who supports Hillary Clinton and insists that Trump is being manipulated by Russian President Vladimir Putin, said that Russians and Iranians in Syria should be killed covertly to pay the price. In fact, we've got this clip. Let's play about 40 seconds of this clip. Here it is.
Donald Trump insulted a Gold Star family whose Muslim son died in Iraq fighting for America. This is just more proof that Trump is a racist.
The things that they need to both go after the Assad government, but also to have the Iranians and the Russians pay a little price, right? When we were in Iraq, the Iranians were giving weapons to the Shia militia who were killing American soldiers, right? The Iranians were making us pay a price. We need to make the Iranians pay a price in Syria. We need to make the Russians pay a price.
We make them pay the price by killing Russians.
Yes.
And killing Iranians.
Yes. Covertly.
Okay, that's Michael Morell. Again, former CIA deputy director Michael Morell, supporter of Hillary Clinton, on Bloomberg, Charlie Rose, saying that we need to kill Russians. Bearing in mind, the entire media narrative for months now is that Donald Trump is a danger to the world. Even though he said, you know, he will try to have good relations with Russia, with Vladimir Putin, Donald Trump's a danger to the world. He's Hitler. He's going to cause World War III. Meanwhile, you've got Hillary Clinton supporters openly urging for America to go into Syria and start killing Russians, because that's really going to make the world a safer place, isn't it? Killing Russian troops and potentially starting World War III. Yeah, that's really safe. That's a really good idea, given the history of what Hillary Clinton represents and has advocated. given what she advocated in Syria. Remember, it was Hillary Clinton in Libya as well, who was overruling Pentagon generals who wanted to avoid that quagmire in Libya, wanted to avoid overthrowing yet another secular government and allowing jihadists and allowing ISIS to fill in that vacuum. It was Hillary Clinton pushing those policies. We came, we saw, he died. It led to the rise of ISIS. It led to the deaths of tens of thousands of Muslims. It led to the international migrant crisis. And now you've got her cheerleaders saying that we should go into Syria and kill Russians. And yet they tell us that it's Donald Trump who is a danger to the world. Absolutely insane. We'll be back for the final segment. Don't go away. Final segment of the Alex Jones Show. Again, I urge you to go to InfoWarsStore.com. We're not funded by corrupt dictatorial governments like CNN, so we actually need you to buy the products for us to continue to build this operation. So please go to InfoWarsStore.com. We've got InfoWars Premium Power Pack for 20% off. Start getting off the grid with a portable InfoWars Premium Power Pack that is now 20% off at InfoWarsStore.com. It's a rechargeable power pack, really useful. It can run or charge all of your electronic devices, act as a car emergency jump starter or a backup preparedness power supply. Again, 20% off on the Premium Power Pack at InfoWarsStore.com. Let's cover a few final news stories here in the last few minutes. Conservative Treehouse reports 62-year-old Trump supporter beaten with crowbar for wearing Trump T-shirt. Media makes headline about T-shirt. I doubt you could find a more representative story to exemplify the current state of American journalism than this one. So again, you've heard the story. A 62-year-old man in New Jersey was minding his own business, walking down the street, wearing a Donald Trump T-shirt. Of course, it triggered a special snowflake who beat him with a crowbar. But this is what the headline out of New Jersey read. Man's Trump T-shirt sparked crowbar attack, cops say. So it wasn't the individual with the crowbar going insane and whacking this guy with the Trump T-shirt. It wasn't his fault. It was the T-shirt that caused it. Blame the T-shirt. Like blaming cartoonists who draw Muhammad when they get massacred by jihadists. It's their fault. They shouldn't have triggered the precious snowflakes in the first place. Heat Street reports, media freaks when Donald Trump jokes about Second Amendment stay silent when his life is threatened. Of course, you know about this by now. He made this joke about the Second Amendment, misspoke, whatever you want to call it. Meanwhile, you've got actual assassins like we had last month that turn up to Donald Trump events, try to kill him, and it's barely even mentioned in the media. But Donald Trump made a joke that some people got triggered and offended by and said could possibly be violent. My God, the horror. Meanwhile, you've got actual assassins at Donald Trump events and nobody gives a damn. Remember the guy back in March who rushed the stage and tried to physically attack Donald Trump? CNN gave him a platform and made him into some kind of icon. The left celebrated. You've got people on Twitter every single frigging day saying how they want to kill Donald Trump. Nobody cares about it. People actively plotting to assassinate him. Nobody cares about it. Say one misconstrued thing about Hillary Clinton. Everybody freaks out. Again, complete double standard of the media. Going back to Germany, again, the center of cultural enrichment right now. High-ranking ISIS member is arrested in Germany following threats the terror group planned to bomb football stadiums. Remember, we had that cover-up of the terror attack on a football stadium last year, which we reported on. Again, the police seeing bombs in the ambulance, the media, the government covered it up. Well, now they've arrested a 24-year-old man who, surprise, surprise, is an asylum seeker, a refugee. You know, given that 21% of Syrian refugees support ISIS, it's not a surprise that many of them are now carrying out terrorist attacks in Germany. And Angela Merkel says, bring more in. Even as their tourist economy slumps, even as people leave the country to claim asylum in Russia because they're so panicked about what's happening. Absolutely amazing. We've got more stories. We haven't got time for them. Claremont students refuse to live with whites. That's out of campus reform.
Again, they're saying reverse racism is not a thing yet. It's just racism. Absolutely amazing. This from the same people who want to reintroduce segregation because they're really progressive. But that's going to wrap it up for the fourth hour of the Alex Jones Show. Alex will be back tomorrow, 11 to 2. Stay tuned for InfoWars Nightly News, breaking news at InfoWars.com.